Presentation of the Nebraska Rural Radio Association. This is the Platte Valley Company's pregame show, brought to you by Platte Valley Companies, your premier provider of financial services. Live from the Logos broadcast booth, here is Zach McKinstry.
Welcome into the Platte Valley Company's pregame show and the Logos broadcast booth. Logos is your home for all your screen printing and embroidery needs. Shop the showroom or have something custom made at Logos, 1344 10th Street. In Garing, we're back at Oregon Trail Park Stadium here in Garing, Nebraska, for Game 1 of the three-game series between the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs and your Western Nebraska Pioneers. The Pioneers coming off a win in their last two outings against the Canyon County Spuds. Longest series of the year, four games against the Spuds, losing the first two, the Game 2 on that walk-off loss. Cade McGee's first loss of the year since then, coming back pretty nicely with a big 12-5 win in Game 3, and then the 8-6 win last night. Let's recap it. The Pioneers would end up trailing early on. One run would score for the Canyon County Spuds in the second inning on an RBI single from Cody Vaith, and that would put them on top by a score of 1-0. But the Pios would answer quickly in the top of the third inning, an RBI single from Cade McGee, as he had a nice night at the plate. He would tie the game in that third inning. The Spuds would add two more in the bottom of the fourth after a good inning, which featured a lot of small balls, singles, bunts, and then the RBI sack fly off the bat of Noah Denny. They would lead 3-1. The Pios scoring one in each of the next three innings, the fifth, the sixth, and the seventh, all after a good amount of hits. They ended with 14 hits in Game 4, leaving only eight on base. And then they broke it open in that eighth inning, scoring four runs on a two RBI single from Eric Smelko, the Taco John's player of the game, as he won it for the Pioneers in that one. And they advance now to 31-12 on the season and two games back in the Clark Division in the second half. Meanwhile, the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs are hot as well, 31-14 after winning their last four, including a home and away win against the Badlands Big Sticks in their last two. So tonight on the mound, it should be a good pitching matchup. Caden Edwards will pitch for the Pioneers. The lefty is 0-1 on the season, all-star with a 2.81 ERA, 7 starts, 32 innings of work, and 44 strikeouts to 15 walks. Meanwhile, Kanan Marrow for the visiting Souris Valley Sabre Dogs, he's got a 5-1 record, but only 4 starts. This is his fifth. He has also pitched 4 games out of relief, has a pair of saves, and 32 strikeouts to 21 walks in this season. So it should be a good matchup. Both teams a little bit tired after long bus rides today, but we'll see how they react and bounce back here at Oregon Trail Park for Game 1 of the three-game set. We're going to take a quick break here on the Platte Valley Company's pregame show. When we come back, we'll have the Scotts Bluff Screen Printing pregame interview. See Shane and his crew at Scotts Bluff Screen Printing for all your winter, summer, fall, or spring sports needs. Talked with head coach Antonio Garcia about last series, the momentum coming into tonight, and how big this series is. All that and more coming up on the Platte Valley Company show. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
Dooley Oil has been providing great service since 1968, located at 2475 10th Street in Garing. They are your distributor for premium Shell lubricants and also carry most all other major brands. Dooley Oil is the only master distributor of Howell's Fuel Additive in Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado. Dooley Oil is your extreme diesel fuel provider for the three-state region. Remember, delivery is available. So for all of your ag and commercial lubricant and fuel needs, trust the folks at Dooley Oil. Thank you for your patronage. Dooley Oil, committed to you.
8-year-old Lucas Ritz had a life jacket on and the close supervision of his mother when he was killed while swimming in their marina. A boat plugged into the shore power was leaking electricity, and Lucas swam into the energized water. His father urges everyone to learn from their tragedy and help keep water recreation safe.
Electrocuted in the water from a leaky boat while touching absolutely nothing. Please, please, educate yourself about electric shock drowning.
See their story at safeelectricity.org. Brought to you by Chimney Rock and Roosevelt Public Power Districts, your Touchstone Energy Partners.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome into the Scottsbluff Screen Printing pregame interview here with head coach Antonio Garcia. Winning the last two against the Canyon County Spuds and splitting that series, are you looking to carry over that momentum into this series against Souris Valley?
Yeah, absolutely. Obviously, we started getting a little hotter with the bats those last two games. So hopefully against a team like this, we can carry it and hopefully get a big, big series win going into the All-Star break.
Yeah, this is probably one of the harder tests that your team's going to face so far to this point. Souris Valley winning the Lewis Division first half and having some fantastic talents on their team with some unbelievable eye-popping stats. What can we expect for the team going into this one?
Yeah, I just expect us to compete. I mean, I know we all believe we're the best team in the league, so we just need to go out and prove it and play our brand of baseball. I know all the guys are exhausted, but hopefully we can put forth a good enough effort tonight to get a win.
Yeah, running into the All-Star ranks on a little bit of fumes, you know, losing Jack Wagner and Dalton Frank out for the season. How can you replace those guys, and what's the mentality in the dugout?
Yeah, it's just next man up mentality, same stuff that goes on with these guys at school. It's really tough to see those guys have to go home. Great kids, great ball players, and we're going to miss their presence on the field and in the dugout. But we just wish them a speedy recovery. But as far as what we're doing here, we still got to take care of business. Next man up mentality. Guys are going to get more opportunities, and they just got to make the most of them.
Yeah, both teams definitely tired after long bus rides coming into game one of this series. But you got Caden Edwards on the mound. He's done great so far this year. What can we expect from him tonight?
Well, he didn't go on the bus, so he's well rested and ready to go. Yeah, I'm really excited to see Caden on the mound again. Hopefully he can build off a great start last week and carry it into the day against a really good hitting team.
All right, well, good luck tonight, Coach.
Thanks, Zach.
Hydrotex Lubrication is an industry leader in high-performance motor oils, greases, and fuel improvers. Hydrotex's main priorities are to provide the best products and the most efficient and reliable service to fit the customer's application needs. For more information on how Hydrotex can help you, call Phil and Nick at 308-635-8162. Stop into our new showroom at 2860 Holiday Park Drive in Gearing and see the products and services they offer, as well as purchase any products that you need.
Building a legacy doesn't happen by accident. It starts with a plan. Hi, I'm Jody Raziska, Raymond James Financial Advisor at Platte Valley Investment Center. From private wealth management to customized estate planning and wealth transfer, you can turn to us for comprehensive financial planning. We invest time in getting to understand you and your financial goals, so together we can create a strategy to help you live a life well planned.
Platte Valley Investment Center, Inc., Scottsbluff, Nebraska, is not a registered broker, dealer, and is independent of Raymond James Financial Services. Securities offered through Raymond James Financial Services, member FINRA, SIPC.
Hi, I'm Austin Dillon, Fleet Manager at Fremont Ford in Scottsbluff, Nebraska. I encourage all farmers, ranchers, and business owners to get in touch with me if you are looking for a new vehicle. We have specific programs through Ford that can save you a drastic amount of money on your new purchase. It would be my pleasure to discuss these savings with you. There's no better time to purchase a new work truck or personal vehicle than right now. Please get in touch with me by calling the dealership at 308-635-3701. I look forward to helping you on your new purchase.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome back to the Platte Valley Company's pregame show in the Logos broadcast booth. Logos is your home for all your screen printing and embroidery needs. Shop the showroom or have something custom made at Logos, 1344 10th Street in Gearing. Got a good matchup coming tonight between the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs and the Western Nebraska Pioneers. We're going to step aside, let you listen to the national anthem when we come back. First pitch here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was
National anthem has been sung, and we're ready for first pitch. Pios will warm up. Sabre Dogs will come to the plate on the other side of this quick break. We'll have the starting lineups, the Team Auto Center key to the game, and opening pitch here for game one of the three-game series between these two squads. You've been listening to the Platte Valley Company's pregame show. Up next, Pios Baseball.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said,
"Get your hands off my burrito."
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations in Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
With scorching hot summer temperatures, it's hard to think about staying warm this winter. Fortunately, Wesco can take those worries away with propane contracts available now to lock in your heating costs throughout the winter. Wesco has been serving our propane customers for decades with unmatched service at fair prices delivered by trained, experienced, and certified technicians. Call now for winter contract pricing options. Wesco. Service. Solutions. Success.
Wesco's your best value through and through.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome back to Gearing, Nebraska, as we get set for first pitch here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium between the 31-12 Western Nebraska Pioneers and the 31-14 Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. These two teams are the top two teams in the league in overall record. In the second half, the Pios sit two games out of the Clark Division at an 8-4 rate. Meanwhile, Souris Valley won the first half of the Lewis Division and in the lead right now by a game over Mining City with their 9-5 record. Caden Edwards on the mound, and he gets set to deal the first pitch home as we get set to get underway. That one finds the zone. It's in there for strike one. Opening pitch is brought to you by Papa Murphy's Pizza at 2801 Avenue B in Scottsbluff. It's love at 425 degrees, and don't forget to register for the Papa Murphy's Text Club for a sweet deal. The next one popped up shallow center field, ranging out as the second baseman ruts, but it'll drop in. And we're underway with a base hit off the bat of Justin Cooper to get us going in the top of inning number one. That'll bring up Alan Greer, and it's time now for our WNCC starting lineups. The starting lineups are brought to you by Western Nebraska Community College. From diplomas to degrees, it's for me. Learn more at WNCC.edu. Justin Cooper obviously leading it off for the Sabre Dogs as he stands on first base. Alan Greer will man center field and bat second. Jordan Williams in the three-hole in left. Steven Moretto will be the cleanup man at third base. Cullen Hannigan behind the plate, catching and batting fifth. Drew Miller will DH tonight, followed by Ethan Moore, Gunnar McGran, and Jared Breedwell. First pitch here to the two-hole hitter in the zone, and the next count starts 0-1. Defensively tonight for the Pioneers, JT Walden in left, Eric Smelko in center, and Alex Zerfus in right. Three strong outfielders out there for the Pioneers. Clay Cutter at third, Mazzaferro at short, Kellen Rutz at second, and Cade McGee at first. This one misses a little low. The check swing, he did not go, and the count evens up at 1-1. Jake English will be behind the plate for the Pioneers. And, of course, Caden Edwards on the mound with his 0-1 record to this point in seven starts, a 2.81 ERA. And one of the best pitchers in the league earned a bid as an all-star player. And we'll get some action in that all-star game following this series. This one home, shot out towards second. Rutz fields, but doesn't get it out of his glove. Can't get the transition cleanly. It'll be a line out. And back safely to the bag is Cooper, one away. So that brings up the three-hole hitter Jordan Williams, and Minot native, well, not necessarily native, playing at Minot State University, so definitely aware of the area, but actually from Bruton, Alabama, long way away in the southeast. As he gets his first at bat against these Pioneers this year, first pitch home, this one swung on, roped foul down the left side, and it'll be strike one. Williams this season has had a pretty good season for the Sabre Dogs to this point. Outfielder out of Minot State. He's batting .361 in the 17 games he's played. Five doubles, a triple, and three home runs to this point. Here comes the 0-1 now from Edwards as he delivers. That one in the dirt blocked, and the count will even up at 1-1. Cooper at first base currently sits at 13 stolen bags, 13 for 18 on the season, and this is a team that can absolutely move it. Very aggressive on the base paths, and they've got some guys that are really high up there in that stolen base category. Edwards looks over to first, and the lefty will come home. Popped up behind the plate, but English will watch it sail over this screen, and the count goes to 1-2. So Caden Edwards ahead in the count here looking for out number two. The speedy Cooper on first base has a pretty big lead against the left-hander Edwards as he'll try again. Once again, he'll come set out of the stretch, comes straight home. Curveball tipped at the plate. And just enough from Williams to stay alive as he will get to see another up there. Nice pitch from Edwards to get the chase, and he's still in the driver's seat as the count remains 1-2. Pioneers receiving the news this morning that two of their players heading back home after some injuries will end their season. As here comes the 1-2 now from Edwards. That one misses on the inside part of the plate. Williams stepped out. I think he wanted time. He didn't get it. But it will be a 2-2 count. Edwards will slowly return to the mound. Confusing pitch there for everyone involved. It looked like Cooper got a good jump off of first base as well. He's got another nice lead. Quick pitch home. This one swung on, fouled back, and the count will remain 2-2. So those two players for the Pioneers, All-Star Dalton Frank, shortstop out of Florida Atlantic, received word that he tore his ACL this morning, out for the season, as it's a tough beat. He has been fantastic when he's been healthy for the Pioneers this season. And Jack Wagner, in his short stint with the Pioneers, was really good. But has torn up his UCL. This one comes home. It's called strike three. Throw down to second, not in time. Cooper will pick up the stolen bag, but Williams will return to the dugout with a strikeout, first of the day for Edwards, and it's out number two. Now a conversation. Antonio Garcia is arguing that the left fielder Williams was leaning over the plate and blocked the throw down to second, and he's heated from the jump. Already some arguments here early on, but he'll return to the dugout unsuccessful. There will be two outs, but the runner in scoring position is Cooper.
Now at bat from Sacramento State.
Steven Moretto, third base, batting cleanup tonight. Gets a chance to hit and a chance to drive in that run out at second base. Another good lead for the shortstop out there at second as Edwards looks over and delivers home. This one misses inside, scoots away from English, but not far enough for the runner to advance. It's ball one. Moretto, another Canadian in the league from British Columbia, where he attended Notre Dame High School in British Columbia, now attending Sacramento State University in the Big Sky Conference. Just finished his freshman year there, played 58 games as a true freshman. No, rather, that's incorrect, as here comes a 1-0 home. That one swung on, rocked out into left field. Left fielder taking it a couple steps back towards the track, and Walden pulls it in for out number three. So we'll tell you about that on the other side. Instead, it's three outs for Caden Edwards. They leave a runner stranded at second base, and the Sabre Dogs go scoreless here in the top of the first. We head to the bottom half as the Pios come to the plate. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB.
Need a piece of glass for your car, windshield, side windows, or back? Call the guys at Midwest Auto Used Parts for all your auto glass and auto parts needs. Midwest Auto Used Parts is accepting applications for an auto dismantler, part puller. If you enjoy working on cars, apply in person at Midwest Auto Used Parts. You must have basic knowledge of car parts. Pay will be based on experience and abilities. Work Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 with weekends off. Apply today at Midwest Auto Used Parts, 2400 North 10th Street in Gary. Call 632-6600.
Drive happy this summer with auto insurance from J.G. Elliott. Hi, I'm Lila Nash, and when you choose J.G. Elliott as your auto insurance provider, you'll get a variety of options and deductibles, including car rental coverage and customized equipment coverage, so you can get on the road without the worry. If a new boat, motorcycle, RV, or ATV is part of your summer plan, we can insure that too. Plus, you can bundle your vehicle and home insurance to save even more. J.G. Elliott has insurance coverage for all your summer adventures. J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
Our mission at Elite Physical Therapy and Wellness is to provide both preventative and rehabilitative services. At Elite Physical Therapy in Scottsbluff and Gearing, patients count on the experience and compassion of our team in treating work and sports injuries, help you recover from surgery, or just help you get back doing what you love most. Flexible scheduling to meet your needs, and we are right here in Scottsbluff and Gearing to serve you. Katie and Shelly are across from Walgreens on West 27th Street and next to Fresh Foods and Gearing. Elite Physical Therapy and Wellness, delivering the treatment you need and the care you deserve.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome back to the bottom of the first inning here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as the Pioneers come to the plate for the first time tonight, and they will face Canaan Morrow, out of right-hander out of Paris Junior College. 16 appearances for them this year, a 3-3 overall record, 4 saves, 16.2 innings of work, 24 Ks, and a 3.78 ERA, and he has been just as good this season for the Sabre Dogs, with a 5-1 record in 8 games pitched. Only 4 starts to this point. Also has a pair of saves and 27.2 innings under the belt of the righty as he gets set to pitch to this lineup. Pios will come to the plate starting with Eric Smelko, who has been fantastic to this point this season. 9-for-20 last series with 4 RBIs, 5 runs, and a pair of doubles as the switch hitter will get things going.
Eric Smelko.
And the right-hander, Morrow delivers the first. That one just misses outside. It's ball one, and the Pioneers' bats are underway as Eric Smelko will be ahead. Easiest all-star selection for the Pioneers this year. He shoots this one out into right field, and he'll get things underway with a base knock. And the Pios have their leadoff man on with the single. Eric Smelko, again, leads the team in average, has been absolutely fantastic for the Pioneers this season from both sides of the plate. Again, 9-for-20 last series, and his batting average is sky high, up in the 381 category. That's 61 hits and 160 at-bats, 5 doubles, 2 triples, and 2 home runs as well. As Cade McGee will see the first pitch, that one misses off the plate, and he starts ahead 1-0. Smelko currently second in the RBI total as well, and that's from the leadoff spot all year, which goes to show how talented he has been for this Pioneers club. The next one home, that one just misses upstairs, and it'll be a 2-0 hitter's count to Cade McGee, the recent high school graduate out of Tucson, Arizona, and future Gonzaga baseball player, as he'll be contending Gonzaga in the fall. Watches this one catch the zone, and the count moves to 2-1 now on McGee. He has been just as good. Earned an all-star bid as a pitcher, but when Dalton Frank went down, they replaced him in the all-star game as a batter. So he'll earn both all-star honors. Quick pickoff over to first base, and Smelko just dives back in safely. For McGee, he is at a 285 rate to this point in the season, but also in the top 3 in the league in walks. 35 walks this season and an on-base up above 400. This one fouled away out to the right side. And the count will even up at 2-2. And you can see why he's been so good at drawing walks. His plate discipline has been fantastic. Been fouling off 2 strike pitches, and every at-bat he steps up to the plate. It seems like it's a quality at-bat. And we'll see if he can continue that streak here. 2-2 count, nobody out. Smelko on first base. The pitch home. Swung on, roped up the middle, and over the glove of the second baseman into center field. Back-to-back base hits open up this bottom of the first inning, and the Pios are marching, runners on first and second, and nobody out here for Alex Zerfus at the plate. So Zerfus is 5-for-17 last series, but that doesn't tell the whole story, as he was 0-for-5 last night. All 5 of those outs, I should say, were absolutely scorched off the bat of Zerfus, and he has been squaring up the ball, seeing it well, but just hitting it right at some of the opposing teams. Trying to avoid the red jersey and baby blue pants of the Sabre Dogs tonight. First pitch to him. That one catches the outside corner, and the count goes to 0-1 as Antonio Garcia gives some signs to his team. The Pios have not been afraid of the double steal this year. They seem to do it a lot, and it's been successful a lot of the time. Pioneers top three in the league in stolen bags and lowest caught stealing. Zerfus shows bunt here, so everybody comes in, corners in. This one misses off the plate, and the count evens up at 1-1. Defensively tonight for the Sabre Dogs, it's Steven Moretto at third, Justin Cooper at short, Gunnar McGran at second, Ethan Moore at first, and Cullen Hannigan behind the plate with an outfield of Jordan Williams, Alan Greer, and Jared Breedwell left to right. 1-1 home. This one pulled back, and that misses the zone. Nice eye from Alex Zerfus as he gets ahead in the count, 2-1 now. Lots of games going on around the league, and they're all going on at the same time, unlike the last series. Caldwell, the latest games to start, which means most of the time, by the time the game was over, by the time our game started, other games were over. Zerfus shows bunt here, but pulls back and watches it catch the zone to even the count at 2-2. As the corners will head back to their normal position with two strikes, third base deep, first base deep as well, and we'll see if Zerfus will try and lay down one here or protect with two strikes. Right-handed outfielder, and another Gonzaga Bulldog steps into the box, a very open stance for him, as he'll see the 2-2 from the right-hander, Kanan Morrow. This one struck up the middle and base hit into center field. They're going to send Smelko around third. He's coming home. Throw is into third. Cade McGee slides in safely, and it's an RBI single for Alex Zerfus. Three hits open up the game for the Pioneers, and they come in hot as they lead 1-0. So Alex Zerfus gets rewarded for a hard hit ball this time, as that was not the case last night, and I'm sure that's relieving. Cade McGee, nice base running, scoots up to third, slides in head first safely as Moretto couldn't hang on to the short hop. And on the throw, Alex Zerfus will advance up to second base to put runners on second and third. Still nobody out, and the Pios out to a 1-0 lead. First pitch to Walden, misses off the plate. That one's ball one. Walden, the third of three straight Gonzaga Bulldogs that hit tonight. And he'll bat in the cleanup role. Jake English behind him, followed by Clay Cutter, Nate Schwartz, Kellen Rutz, and then Jared Mazzaferro. The 1-0. This one, check swing. Did he go? They appeal. He did not. And somehow, JT Walden holds his bat back as he looked like he wanted to unleash on that pitch. Instead, he's got a 2-0 count. Walden, another all-star, and will be participating in the home run derby for the Pioneers this season, as here comes a 2-0 to him. That one crosses the plate, and the count now 2-1, as Walden sees the first strike against him from the right-hander. A hot start to this one for the Pioneers, as that has not been the case as of late. The 2-1, that one misses off the plate, and it's a 3-1 hitter's count to Walden. Last night, not scoring until the third inning. Game three, they did not cross the plate all the way until the seventh, but won that game 12-5. Well, they scored in the fourth, but all the big runs coming in the seventh, eighth, and ninth, 4-3-4. As this one shot the other way, it'll score a run. Going to be a tough play. Walden busting it down the line, but third baseman Steven Moretto fires on to first for out number one. A productive out number one brings home Cade McGee, and the Pios out to a 2-0 lead here in the bottom of the first. And that'll bring Jake English to the plate as Zerfus remains at second base. So Jake English will get to bat again here, back behind the plate after he was out of the lineup last night, and then game three was behind the plate, but also was a DH twice in that Canyon County Spud series, as the first pitch to him misses for ball one. English, another University of Kansas Jayhawk on this Pioneers roster. as head coach Antonio Garcia there as well. This one now skied out into right field. Right fielder underneath it. He'll pull it in, and no tag from Zerfus as he returns to the second base bag. That line out will go in as out number two, and Mero now one out away from getting out of this bottom of the first. So Clay Cutter gets to come up to the plate here. 5-for-14 last series with a pair of RBIs and a pair of runs. Not too shabby. Defensively, he's had some struggles in the last couple of series, but looking to bounce back at third base tonight. He had three errors in game four against the Spuds last night. Shoots this one, dribbler up the middle. Shortstop coming in, field, fires on the run. Going to be a tough play, and it can't be picked. Walden rounds and comes home. He'll score. The Pios will now have a 3-0 lead as it's Zerfus that crosses the plate, but heads up base running from him as he steals a run, and the error produces now the third run of the game for the Pioneers.
Now at the plate from Elodie Junior College, Nate Schwartz.
So Nate Schwartz comes to the plate here with a runner on first base, two out, first pitch swinging. He fouls it back to the screen for strike one. Cutter sending that up the middle, but again, that infield grass killing that foul or killing that grounder up the gut, and it was a tough play for Justin Cooper running in to get that ball. Clay Cutter with a little bit of speed as well, so that certainly doesn't help. The throw low, and it couldn't be picked. Zerfus rounding third, and first baseman Ethan Moore couldn't retrieve the ball and throw home in time to give that Pios the 3-0 lead. 0-2 count quickly here to Nate Schwartz as leading off of first is Cutter. And Morrow will try and come home again. Here comes the 0-2 now from the righty. Fastball outer half just misses, and it's a 1-2 count now. Currently 27 pitches and still not out of inning number one now for the starter for the Sabre Dogs. As that pitch count is just continuing to rise. This one swung on, fouled back, and he won't get Nate Schwartz as easily as he fouls this one away to stay alive, and he'll see another 1-2. Morrow again entered tonight with a 7.15 ERA in his 27.2 innings of work. But looking for out number three here. Pitch home, misses off the plate, gets away, and it'll allow Cutter to scoot up into scoring position as it's a 2-2 count, and the wild pitch scoots the third baseman up in extra base. Schwartz, 7 at-bats for him last series against the Spuds with a pair of hits and a run. Looking to add another hit here and try and bring home the fourth run of the inning. The 2-2. That one inside, called strike three. Sits down Nate Schwartz, and he'll be a looking strikeout to wrap up the inning. Not before the Pioneers had three runs on three hits. And an impressive start to the day for the Pios as Caden Edwards will return to the mound here for the second with a 3-0 lead. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Life has a way of throwing unexpected events and new opportunities our way. When life goals change with time or if fluctuating markets throw your plan off course, Wells Fargo Advisors' investment planning process offers the flexibility to make the adjustments you need to help you live the life you want. When life happens, we can help. For more information, call Ryan Windhorst, Senior Vice President of Investments, today at 632-7561. That's 632-7561.
Don't miss the savings during Lowe's Just for Pros event. Stop by the Pro Desk and get an extra 5% off volume savings orders over $1,500. Plus, look for more savings across the store, including tools, paint, lighting, and other pro essentials to help you get the job done right. Shop today at Lowe's, the new home for pros. Discount on eligible product only and reflected in quote. Terms and exclusions apply. See Pro Desk in store for details, now through July 30th, U.S. only.
Want to hear something amazing? Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year, automatically, dollar for dollar, with no limit on how much you can earn. Extra cash? Come on, how amazing is that? In fact, it's even more amazing when you realize all the places where Discover is accepted. 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. So when it comes to Discover, get used to hearing yes more often. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen Report. Limitations apply.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome back. Top of the second inning as Caden Edwards will take the mound for the second time tonight. Allowed the leadoff bloop single to Justin Cooper. Since then, got the three outs he needed. Three straight retired. And he'll face the five-hole hitter Colin Hannigan to lead off this top of the second. The lefty winds and delivers the first pitch home. And that one just misses upstairs for ball one. Time for tonight's key to the game brought to you by Team Auto Center, home of the lifetime warranty on every new vehicle from Team Auto. Pioneers need solid defense tonight to support the good pitching effort of Caden Edwards as this one's lined out into left field. It'll be a single. The second hit of the game for the Sabre Dogs puts another leadoff man on first base to open the inning as Drew Miller will try and follow him. But last night for the Pios, it was a three-error performance. Prior to that, two errors, two more errors in game two, and two more in game one. So nine total errors in four games for the Pios as they try and straighten it out there defensively and support the man on the mound, Caden Edwards, who's been fantastic to this point as he already has a 3-0 lead. First pitch home here. Whoa, this one runs up and in on the left-handed hitting DH Drew Miller as that will go for ball one. Miller bats lefty, throws righty, and is a utility guy out of Pryor, Oklahoma. And here comes the 1-0. That one swung on, tipped back, and the count will even up at one. For Miller, out of Neosho County Community College. That's where he played his most recent 2021 season before transferring to Wichita State, where he'll play in the spring and go to school there this fall. Here comes the 1-1. That one swung on, tipped in and out of the mitt of Jake English, and the count will go now to 1-2. Edwards already a strikeout tonight. Currently sits at 45 on the year. And as Pio's pitching leads the way in that category, more strikeouts than any other team in the league. 1-2 home. This one rocked out into right field and deep. Down the left field, right field line and gone. That one sails over the right field wall and over the second deck of ads out there. As no chance for Alex Zerfus to field that one in right. And it's a two-run bomb to cut the deficit to one as it's now 3-2. A 1-2 pitch from Caden Edwards ran a little too much over the plate, and Miller made him pay. He scorched that one off the bat as Drew Miller picks up his fifth home run of the year and his 26th and 27th RBIs on the two-run home run. So exactly what the doctor ordered for this Sabredags offense, as this one's now popped up shallow right field. Kellen Rutz coming out, called off by Alex Zerfus, and he'll pull it in for out number one. So Caden Edwards will try and bounce back after that 1-2 two-run home run. And it cuts the lead to 3-2 for Edwards this year. And the Pioneers pitching staff in general, they really haven't given up a lot of home runs. As that one misses for ball one. Brian Webb currently leads the team with five home runs against. For Caden Edwards out there, that was his first home run allowed all season, as this Pioneer squad has really done a good job of limiting those home runs. As here comes the 1-1 now to the left-handed hitter. This one shot out into left field, and that'll drop in base hit. Cut off by JT Walden, and he'll throw it in, which means that Gunnar McGran will have to turn on the brakes and be content with a single. It's the third hit of the inning, and with one out, the tying run is on first base for the Sabre Dogs. Nine-hole hitter Jared Breedwell will come up to the plate here with a runner on first.
Bottom of the order for the Sabre Dogs.
And one away.
San Francisco, Jared Breedwell.
As the first pitch home to him misses somewhere, it's ball one. The Pioneers, last in the league in giving up home runs, with 17 entering today, make it 18 after the two-run homer from Drew Miller. Well, Souris Valley is in the top of that category, allowing 39 home runs this season. Surprising, as the second best team in the league has given up the most home runs by a good margin, 39, and six more than the second place Casper Horseheads. 1-0 count. Edwards comes home again. This one struck out into left field again. Long way to run for Smelko in center, trying to run it down, and he will. Nice play by the center fielder, Eric Smelko, showing off the range. And Basket catching it on the run for out number two. Eric Smelko has some good speed. He currently leads the team in stolen bases. And he is fantastic out there defensively, as he covers up a ton of ground in center field. So two outs as McGran will have to return to first base. In the top of the order, will bat second time through for the Sabre Dogs, starting with Justin Cooper. First pitch home. That one catches the zone, and the count goes to 0-1. For Cooper, he's 1-for-1 today. Had that single in his first at-bat of the night. And then stole second base, but was left stranded out there at second after Edwards got the next three outs. 0-1 home from the lefty. Runner fake goes here as this one's fouled away, and the count will go to 0-2 on Cooper, the infielder at Texas Southern from Fort Worth, Texas, and has had some good playing time at Texas Southern as well. 39 starts this year. And here comes another home. This one fouled back and spoiled by the leadoff man, as the count remains at 0-2. A 297 average at the Division I level, playing in the Southwest Athletic Conference. As Edwards will try again, the lefty sets, looks to first, and delivers an 0-2 pitch. Swung on, fouled off right side this time, and slowly working on that timing is Justin Cooper as he tries to adjust. His single in the first inning was a bloop single over the glove of second baseman Kellen Rutz as he ranged out into shallow right field. Looking for more solid contact here. Edwards will come home with an 0-2. That one up and away moves the count now to 1-2, as Edwards still in the driver's seat.
Game point.
Had this count to Drew Miller as he hit the two-run home run earlier this inning. And so he'll try and get a chase pitch here. 1-2. This one struck out into left field, and that'll be a base hit. Justin Cooper 2-for-2 tonight. And another two-out hit puts runners on first and second now with two away. So that's now the fourth hit of the inning for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. They have five hits already to this point, and not out of the second inning. The Pioneers, three hits in the first inning, and they'll come to the plate 8-9-1 in the bottom of the second if Edwards can find this out number three. Out of Duluth, Minnesota, the lefty will look over to second and now come home. First pitch to Greer. This one swung on, shot out into center field. Eric Smelko takes a couple of steps to his left and pulls it in for out number three. Caden Edwards leaves a couple of runners stranded, but the two-run bomb off the bat of Drew Miller cuts the score to 3-2 here early on as we head to the bottom of the second on the West Coast scoreboard. West Coast Service Solution Success. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
WTT now has a bank shot game room dedicated to bank shot skill games. And better yet, they're open 24/7. Stop in, play, and you might be the next big winner. While you're there, fuel up the car, wash the car, get some pizza, ice cold drinks, or many stacks to choose from. There's no need to drive all over town. It's all here at WTT on the Beltline Highway. Open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. WTT, your one-stop shop to make you a winner.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Play ball!
Whether you're beginning to look for your first home or your fourth, getting pre-qualified for a mortgage loan could make your home search more efficient and effective. Getting pre-qualified could give you the peace of mind that comes with preparation, knowing where you stand. Better yet, pre-qualification is free. It comes with no obligation. Call Jennifer at Castle Limit Mortgage at 308-220-0503 to get started today.
Castle Limit Mortgage, LLC, LLC, for not all of them. People have...
We're back for the bottom of the second inning. Pio is still holding on to a 3-2 lead after the two-run home run from Drew Miller in the second cut the deficit to 3-2. First pitch to Kellen Rutz misses for ball one as he squared around but pulled back. And third baseman Steven Moretto will still play on the edge of the infield grass in case of bunt. No square around here, but this one misses off the plate, and it's a 2-0 start now to the second baseman tonight. Kellen Rutz, a rough series against the Canyon County Spuds offensively, 1-for-10, did have 5 walks at the plate, and watches this one to get ahead 3-0 on the right-hander out of Paris Junior College. Rutz out of Yakima Valley Community College will see a 3-0, and that one misses upstairs, 4-pitch walk. To the leadoff man here in the bottom of the second inning, and Kellen Rutz will start on base for the Pioneers for the bottom of the order in Jared Mazzaferro. That is the first walk of the day for either pitcher, but already 8 hits combined between the two teams. Jared Mazzaferro trying to add to that total as he steps up for his first at bat of the day. 5-for-12 for him against the Canyon County Spuds over the last 4 games. As the first pitch to him, that one misses for ball 5 out of the hand of the right-hander, and that'll bring the catcher Cullen Hannigan in front of the plate to have a quick conversation before squatting back down. As Mazzaferro ahead 1-0. Started with a 362 average in 22 games played as Jared Mazzaferro out of Ohlone Junior College. As here comes the 1-0. That one catches the outside part of the plate, and the count now 1-1. Mazzaferro, 4 doubles, 3 triples, and 13 RBIs this year, as well as 16 runs, and he can move it a little bit out there. And has been getting it done defensively and at the plate with that average. Pickoff to first base, and Rutz dives back in safely after a quick move from Morrow. As he'll return to the mound out of the stretch, and Rutz will take a lead. Kellen Rutz this year, 2-for-2 on stolen bags, takes a slight lead over there at first, gets a secondary as the curveball finds the outside corner, and Mazzaferro now down in the count, 1-2. Having to protect up there at the plate, Mazzaferro, 18 strikeouts this year through 22 games, and trying to avoid going down for number 19. Here comes the 1-2. That one runs in and hits him. 1-2 pitch slips out of the hand of the right-hander, and it'll put the second straight man on base. A walk and a hit by pitch bring up the top of the order for the Pioneers. 2 on and nobody out. So Smelko will come up to the plate, again on a 20-game hit streak at the start of the season, but that was ended against the Spearfish Sasquatch in Spearfish, South Dakota. Bounced back after that with a nice 5-game hit streak before losing it. Shows bunt here, that one misses inside, it's ball one. So he ended his 20-game hit streak in game one against the Badlands Big Sticks. Then had four straight games with a hit before going 0-for-6 in game three. This one now dribbled out to the left side, fielded by the third baseman. Throw on to first is in time. It beats Smelko by a step, but it will be successful as the bunt moves runners into second and third now. Scoring position, one out, and Cade McGee with an opportunity for the Pioneers to get on the board. So for the Pioneers, this has been the one tough point for them all season as they've been getting it done really every category. First pitch to Cade McGee, drops into the zone. It's strike one. But situational hitting for the Western Nebraska Pioneers has struggled. We saw that in the Canyon County Spud Series as there were so many runners left on base and a lot of those coming with less than two outs. First ball to Cade McGee here as that one misses off the plate and the count evens up at 1-1. And the righty will try again. Out of the windup, here he comes. 1-1 pitch home. This one in the dirt, blocked behind the plate by Hannigan, and it moves the count to 2-1, but it keeps the runners at bay out there at second and third. As McGee looks for another RBI, again, he leads the team to this point. Is third on the team, 24 RBIs. Walden leading the team with his 33, but a chance to drive in a few right here. 2-1 home. That one up and in. Whoa, ducking out of the way is Cade McGee. And that'll be ball three to move the count to another hitter's count, 3-1 on the right-handed hitting infielder. He's at first base tonight, primary third baseman. And he'll see a 3-1 now from Morrow. That one misses, ball four. It'll load the bases and bring up the three-hole hitter, Alex Zerfus, with a chance to drive in a few more. Second walk of the game for Morrow. Also a hit by pitch to Jared Mazzaferro. All of those coming this inning. And that'll bring a visit to the mound to talk things over with the starter. As again, his pitch count continues to rise as he will face Alex Zerfus. Already up to 47 pitches and only one out here in the second inning. Pios out to a 3-2 lead on the West Coast scoreboard. But the base is loaded, and Alex Zerfus at the plate, who has been red hot. The RBI single in his first at-bat also came around to score a run on the throwing error from shortstop Justin Cooper. So the conversation will end on the mound. Everybody returns to their positions, and Zerfus will step up to the plate with another chance to hit. Good speed on third and second in Rutz and Mazzaferro. Cade McGee, pretty good speed over there at first as well. Hoping to break up a double play if it comes to that. Outfield arms, Jordan Williams in left, Alan Greer in center, and Jared Breedwell in right. Pios haven't seen them this year, so we'll see if it'll come to it. First pitch home, bounces, and it's ball one as Zerfus starts ahead. Part of the reason that the man on the mound has struggled to this point, allowing the three hits, two walks, and the hit by pitch, is starting 1-0 counts on hitters as he struggled to find that first pitch strike tonight. He'll go ball two here as that one bounces as well. And now Zerfus with a 2-0 count. Nowhere to put him. He'll have to come back to the plate here. And we'll see if Zerfus will swing away. To this point, 28 for 74, a 378 average for the man at the plate. And a chance to drive in some runs. The 2-0. That one inside and low. It's three straight balls now to the three-hole hitter and right fielder. Yes, I'm sure he has the red light at the plate. Bases loaded and a one-run lead. Pio's trying to add another and nowhere to put him. The righty Morrow will deliver again. Here it comes. 3-0 misses low and in. Four straight balls. Walks in a run. And the Pios add to their lead. It is now 4-2. The bases remain loaded. Still one out. And now cleanup man and all-star JT Walden at the plate. That is the second RBI of the day for Alex Zerfus. He gets it the easy way, and that'll move some action into the Sabre Dogs bullpen as some arms start to warm up, do some J-bands down there. Kellen Rutz crosses the plate. And Mazzaferro moves up to third base. So here comes an 0-0 as Morrow tries to start ahead, and he will not. Another first pitch ball as it's a 1-0 count now to JT. Walden, the RBI ground out in his last at bat, and four RBIs last series. As again, he currently leads the team with 33. Looking for some more. This one, check swing, misses low, and the ball moves the count to 2-0. Walden out of Sacramento, California, and a redshirt freshman at Gonzaga. Has been a star for the Pioneers this year. That one misses on the outside half. It's now seven straight balls. And a 3-0 count to JT Walden as he looks to bring home another run. Harris Junior College product comes home with another. That one will find the zone, and it'll end the streak. Pitches out of the strike zone. It's now a 3-1 count. And JT Walden still in the driver's seat. We'll have a hitter's count here. Outfield playing Walden pretty much straight away. The next home misses outside. Ball four. Back-to-back walks bring runners home. It's an RBI walk for Walden. The bases remain loaded, and it is now a 5-2 ball game. So that is three straight walks for the man on the mound. And Jake English will come up to the plate to hit as the warm-up starts to speed up down there in the visitor's bullpen. As Jake English lined out to right field his last at bat, made good contact, trying to find a gap this time. First pitch from Morrow. Swung on, shot foul right side. It'll get out of play. And he'll start ahead 0-1. Iowa's jumping out to a big lead for the first time in a while, as they haven't put up a bunch of runs in the first couple innings since the Pierce series. Three runs in the first in that one, and then a run in the third, and it was a 4-3 lead after three, already 5-2 here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. But English down in the count 0-2, looking to drive in a run with one out. He'll have to protect at the plate. Freshman out of KU will see this one and watch it just miss outside. Moves the count now to 1-2. For Jake English this year, he sits at 14 strikeouts in 19 games and a 3.58 average. Will swing and shoot this one off the pitcher, and that'll score a run. The throw on to third base is not in time, and everyone will move up a bag. A line drive shot from Jake English goes off the backside of pitcher Kanan Morrow, and that'll bring a visit from the coaching staff to talk things over as that one sat him down. English squared that one up. Cooper was heading up the middle, and that one deflected to the left side and allowed everybody to move up. It's an RBI single for Jake English, and the line keeps moving, but now some more conversation with the infield, and warm-ups will continue in the visitor Sabre Dog bullpen. So he'll stay in the game. Kudos to the starter, Morrow, after taking that bullet off the bat of Jake English. English picks up another RBI. That's his first of the night, first hit of the night. It moves Walden up to second, Zerfus up to third, and brings home Cade McGee with still only one out in this inning. Bases remain loaded, and Clay Cutter tries to keep the line moving. First pitch to him misses up and in. It's ball one. So the only out of the inning, the sack bunt from Eric Smelko, and it has been now four straight that have reached base on the three walks and a single. The inning started with a walk to Kellen Rutz and then the hit-by-pitch to Mazzaferro. 1-0 home. This one skied up into shallow center field. Center fielder underneath it. It should be enough for the runner to tag, and he will. Both runners will tag. No, Walden hesitates. We'll have to go back to the second base bag. A mix-up on the base paths, but it short hops the cutoff man, and everybody back safely. And the Pios will avoid that mess. Another run comes home to score on the sacrifice fly, and it is now a 7-2 ball game. Surface tags and scores. Walden looked like he would have been safe at third base, but again, threw on the brakes as English was tagging from first as well. That one misses off the plate. It's ball one to Nate Schwartz as the runners remain at first and second. And Schwartz now the ninth hitter of the inning
as the Pios look to bat around. 1-0 count now as the righty looks to second, delivers home. This one swung on, skied up on the left side. It looks like it'll stay in play. Left fielder in foul territory pulls it in, and Jordan Williams has recorded out number three. Pios add four more and now have seven through the first two innings after a struggle for the man on the mound. Morrow, he'll return to the dugout, and the Sabre Dogs will come back to the plate. Pios taking the field with a 7-2 lead early on. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Hydrotex Lubrication is an industry leader in high-performance motor oils, greases, and fuel improvers. Hydrotex's main priorities are to provide the best products and the most efficient and reliable service to fit the customer's application needs. For more information on how Hydrotex can help you, call Phil and Nick at 308-635-8162. Stop into our new showroom at 2860 Holiday Park Drive in Gearing and see the products and services they offer, as well as purchase any products that you need.
Be the envy of the neighborhood with the new Green Mountain Grill from High Plains Spas and Recreation. In addition to Green Mountain Grills, High Plains Spas and Recreation also has the pellets, cooking spices, rib racks, smoking shelves, covers, and other accessories, as well as replacement parts. If they don't have what you need, they can get it. Yep, get a Green Mountain Grill and be that neighbor that's always admired for the wonderful, yummy barbecue smells. High Plains Spas and Recreation, open 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, 1725 East Overland in Scotts Bluff.
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Caden Edwards will return to the mound and pitch to the 3-4-5 in the order, looking to bounce back after the last inning produced a two-run home run from Drew Miller, which cut it to 3-2 at the time, but the Pios adding four in the bottom of the second extended the lead to 7-2, and Caden Edwards with now a five-run cushion will pitch to Williams for the second time tonight. The lefty stares into his glove and winds to deliver the 0-0. That one swung on and missed. Nice pitch. And coming up empty is Williams for strike one. Again, out of Minot State University. And playing Division II. The Northern Sun Intercollegiate Conference, as that one evens the count at 1-1. Batted 305 at MSU this year, 36 starts, and a pretty good average with that 305 rate, as well as a 594 slugging, 375 on base, and 34 runs, 35 RBIs, as the three-hole hitter will swing at this one, foul it off, and the count evens up at 2-2. Trying to carry it over into the season with the Sabre Dogs, as he has pretty well, 361 average in 17 games with 20 RBIs, but 0-for-1 tonight with a strikeout looking. Edwards comes home again. This one swung on and missed. Two strikeouts tonight for Jordan Williams. He heads back to the dugout as out number one, and that's now two Ks on the afternoon for Edwards. So Steven Moretto comes back up to the plate. Last time he flew out to left field. On Sacramento State's page, he is a freshman, but he has played there for 4 years, so I'm not sure how accurate that is. Eligibility rules get crazier and crazier in the NCAA, but I still don't think that works. This one shot out into center field, but right at center fielder Eric Smelko, and it's two up, two down, two quick outs for the man on the mound, Edwards, as he'll face Cullen Hannigan with two away. Hannigan opened up that second inning with a leadoff single and was the first run to cross the plate as part of that two-run home run over the right field wall, as the lefty Drew Miller, who stands in the on-deck circle, took Edwards deep for the first time this season. First pitch home, misses off the plate for ball one. Again, the Pioneers have sacrificed 18 home runs in their 43 games this season, and that is the league low. That one catches the outside corner, and the count goes to 1-1. It makes it all the more surprising that Hastings is not in that category. They've got about 27 home runs, which is middle of the pack, in their massive field, which is wild. That one flied out to right field. Zerfus underneath it, and a quick inning here for Caden Edwards on the mound. He goes three up, three down, and it sits down the catcher. In this top of the third, Pios come to the plate again with a 7-2 lead on the West Coast scoreboard. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Dooley Oil has been providing great service since 1968, located at 2475 10th Street in Gearing. They are your distributor for premium Shell lubricants and also carry most all other major brands. Dooley Oil is the only master distributor of Howell's Fuel Additive in Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado. Dooley Oil is your extreme diesel fuel provider for the three-state region. Remember, delivery is available. So for all of your ag and commercial lubricant and fuel needs, trust the folks at Dooley Oil. Thank you for your patronage. Dooley Oil, committed to you.
Hi, I'm Austin Dillon, fleet manager at Fremont Ford in Scottsbluff, Nebraska. I encourage all farmers, ranchers, and business owners to get in touch with me if you are looking for a new vehicle. We have specific programs through Ford that can save you a drastic amount of money on your new purchase. It would be my pleasure to discuss these savings with you. There's no better time to purchase a new work truck or personal vehicle than right now. Please get in touch with me by calling the dealership at 308-635-3701. I look forward to helping you on your new purchase.
Marker Ag has been providing consistent quality with the best in guaranteed nutrition from Purina and Lindner's Feeds. Our show feed brands have not only proven their quality through many local and national winners, but have also helped us to get to know you, the Valley's best and brightest. From those who are just starting to those who are looking to try something new, we have the experience and expertise to help you reach your goals for both commercial and show livestock. From the show ring to the sale ring, from the purple ribbons to the pastures, Marker Ag is run for you by people like you. We're located right next to El Cerrito, so stop in today so that we can get to know you better.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
The Pios come to the plate here for the third time tonight in this bottom of the third inning. And as Kellen Rutsch will lead it off and a new arm into the game for the Sabre Dogs, it looks like number 27, which will be Shane Sinclair, out of Spokane Falls Community College, and a Montana native, a little bit earlier than the Sabre Dogs would have hoped to replace the starter. But Morrow finishes with two innings of work, allowing seven runs on four hits, four walks, and a hit-by-pitch as well. And a tough night for him out there on the mound, as Sinclair tries to bridge the gap as long as he can here from inning number three until as far as he can go, as his team trails by five runs, and the 8-9-1 will lead off the inning yet again for the Pioneers. Sinclair, the righty, has had a good amount of outings for the Sabre Dogs this year, 11 total, only one start. And the 10 games out of relief, a total of 29.1 innings of work, 19 strikeouts to 21 walks, as the command has been an issue for him this year. First pitch to Rutsch, shot out towards first, and a first pitch, first out, as the ground ball to the first baseman, Ethan Moore, is taken to the bag himself, and that's out number one. That is the first time tonight the Pioneers have not had their leadoff man on, as that was the case for the Sabre Dogs as well. A leadoff single in the top of the first, as well as a leadoff single in the top of the second, before that third inning went strikeout, lineout, flyout for Caden Edwards on the mound. First pitch home now to Jared Mazzaferro, as he watches this one miss off the plate for ball one. Was hit by a pitch in his last at bat and was down in the count 1-2. Because that's not the pitch you want in the driver's seat. Mazzaferro 5 for 12 last series, 3 runs and an RBI, and has been really good this year for the Pioneers. Swings and shoots this one into right field. Long way to run for the right fielder, back towards the track, and pulls it in just shy of the wall as Mazzaferro takes it opposite field and sends it for a ride. But Jared Breedwell pulls it in that outfield dirt just in front of that right field wall. Two up, two down now for the Pioneers, and Eric Smelko comes up to the plate. Is officially one for one on the day, a single and a run in his first at bat. And a sack bunt in the second, which pushed runners to second and third, nobody out, or one out, rather. And it sent the Pios on a streak of four straight batters reaching en route to the four-run inning and 7-2 lead. First pitch to Smelko, misses for ball one as he watches that one. Taco John's player of the game last night, going 3-for-5, a double and a two RBI single, which put his team out in front. As this one's now skied out into right center field, right fielder ranges over, will call off his center fielder and pull it in for out number three. So the three up, three down top half from Caden Edwards is answered by a three up, three down bottom half by Shane Sinclair. And we head to the fourth as the Pios still lead 7-2 in this one. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB.
Drive happy this summer with auto insurance from J.G. Elliott. Hi, I'm Lila Nash, and when you choose J.G. Elliott as your auto insurance provider, you'll get a variety of options and deductibles, including car rental coverage and customized equipment coverage, so you can get on the road without the worry. If a new boat, motorcycle, RV, or ATV is part of your summer plan, we can insure that too. Plus, you can bundle your vehicle and home insurance to save even more. J.G. Elliott has insurance coverage for all your summer adventures. J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said...
Get your hands off my burrito.
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations in Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
Hi, I'm Kathy Birch from Van Newkirk Real Estate. Van Newkirk Real Estate is more than a realtor. We're your helping hand of knowledge when it comes to the investment you'll make buying that perfect home. We help you discover what's right for you or financial situation. Whether you need commercial, residential, farm property, no one will compare to the service we're about to give you. Call one of our agents today at 632-8700 for the best real estate help possible. And we're happy to show you that service is what we sell.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Caden Edwards returns to the mound here for the top of the fourth inning. The Pios again out to a 7-2 lead against the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. The Pios, the best overall record in the league to this point this year, 31-12. Through 43 games, as the first pitch home to the home run hitter Drew Miller misses for ball one. And the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs right on the tail of the Pioneers. Just one game back, a 31-14 overall record, as this one misses up and in as well, and it's a 2-0 count now to the left-handed hitting DH. Second half, Souris Valley leads by a game over Mining City, 9-5 in this second half. Mining City sitting at 8-6. And that whole Lewis division pretty competitive. 6-7 Badlands. Casper at 5-8. The Spuds splitting the series against the Pioneers are now 5-9. And then Wheat City rounds out that Lewis division at 4-9. So a four-pitch walk first of the day for Caden Edwards opens up this top of the first inning. Or top of the fourth inning. It was a long bus ride, folks. And he'll be on first for Ethan Moore at the plate, who flew out to right field in his last AV.
Now batting from Murray State College, Moore
this season has been very good for the Sabre Dogs. Attending Murray State in the fall. This one popped up right side. Cade McGee over at first base, still struggling to find that ball, and it pushes back into fair territory. But luckily so does McGee. He falls underneath it. And it'll be out number one. Again, Cade McGee used to the other corner of the infield as he's played the most games this year at third base and is an all-star selection as a pitcher, but with Dalton Frank's injury, he'll be replacing him offensively as he's had a pretty good year at the plate as well as on the mound and a lot of potential when he goes to Gonzaga in the fall. So one out now as Gunnar McGran comes up to the plate following his single in the second. was left stranded at second base. And gets his second trip here. Out of Golden West College, as the lefty Caden Edwards will come home. Pitch, that one misses upstairs. It's ball two. Drew Miller over on first base has some good speed for the Sabre Dogs. Again, a team that loves to run, as he is third on the team, 21 stolen bags in 23 attempts. He takes his lead. The lefty comes home. This one swung on, fouled off left side, and it's strike one to McGrant. Again, the Sabre Dogs certainly like to steal bases, as they are on top of that category by a long way. Well, it's two teams that really run the league in stolen bases. The Sioux Falls Sunfish, 163 entering tonight, while the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs, 158, and the Pios are in third, but sit 52 behind them. Pioneers do have second least caught stealings in their 106 stolen bags, and have been very efficient on the base paths. 3-1 home now. This one shot out towards first, and it'll go foul, so the count runs full now, 3-2, and McGrann will have to see another full count pitch. Only one stolen base attempt tonight, and it was successful for Justin Cooper. But again, tougher to steal against the left-hander Caden Edwards, as not only is he decent to the plate, but also from the left side, has a good pickoff move. 3-2 home, he looks over to first, does a double take and comes home. This one, whoa, runs inside, loses control of that 3-2, and it's a hit-by-pitch to put runners on first and second now with one away. I think he overcooked that one out there on the mound, and it's the first hit-by-pitch of the game. Also has a walk, but those are the only two free bases for him. Elsewhere, it has been five hits for Souris Valley to produce their two runs, all coming on that two-run home run. Runners on first and second for the nine-hole hitter, Jared Breedwell, who flew out to center his last at-bat. First pitch to him, shot out towards short, chance at two. Mazzaferro flips to second for one, throw on to first in time. 6-4-3 double play for the middle infield, and the Pioneers get out of the inning. Caden Edwards, just what the doctor ordered, as he goes a scoreless top of the fourth, and we head to the bottom half as the Pios still lead by five. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB, 7-2 on the West Coast scoreboard.
Oh, that's the sound of someone at Papa Murphy's using fresh ingredients to make your pizza. And this, oh, yes, this is the sweet sound of your oven timer telling you that your home-baked Papa Murphy's pizza is done. Because at Papa Murphy's, we believe that Tuesday deserves something different. Like your new way of telling your family pizza is ready.
Come and get it.
Okay. Every Tuesday, get any large pizza for just $10. Papa Murphy's. Change the way you pizza.
Fender bender, hailstorm, couldn't stop on the ice in time. After everyone is safe, Scott's Bluff Body and Paint should be the first call you make. There isn't a better shop in the area. Our highly skilled team is experienced at performing all auto body repair and paint jobs. Stop by anytime and speak to one of our technicians, and we'll do a full inspection to show you just how little our repair services will cost you. Our work is not complete until your car is safe and you're on the road again. Call today, Scott's Bluff Body and Paint, 225-6408.
The Christmas in July sale is going on right now at Vieira Wireless, and we invite you to come in and see just how big the savings are. You'll get up to $1,000 off iPhone plus other top brands. We're your trusted local source for iPhone and iPad. So bring your family, transfer your numbers, and get an extra $200 per line. Let us take care of you by making the transfer easy and free of hassle and hidden fees. For Christmas in July savings, come visit your local Vieira store today.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Leading off this at bat for your Pios from Gonzaga University, Kane McKee.
Pios come to the plate once again. Cade McGee leads things off. First pitch, breaking ball, catch of the zone, and it's strike one to him. First at bat against Shane Sinclair. Yeah, Sinclair looks home and will deliver an 0-1 now to McGee. That one swung on, a heavy hack from him, but he doesn't get it barreled. Fouls it back, and the count now 0-2. Has singled, walked, and scored twice tonight. And so he'll have to protect down 0-2. We'll see if he can extend the at-bat. The pitch home from the righty Sinclair swung on, blooped out into shallow right field, and it'll drop over the second baseman's head. That is perfect 0-2 hitting right there as he got jammed inside but pushed it into right field. And a nice piece of hitting by tonight's first baseman is a leadoff single to put him on first with nobody out. First hit against Shane Sinclair today after he entered into the third and went 1-2-3 as Alex Zerfus comes up to the plate. A walk and a single, two runs and two RBIs tonight. As he's had a hot start to the series. And he certainly would be an all-star candidate had he come on a little bit earlier in the season, not enough games to qualify. As that one just misses for ball one. As he's had a really good season for these Pioneers. Currently sits at a high 378 average through 22 games played. Four doubles and a home run. Again, Smelko leading among active players. The 1-0 home, this one way outside. The count now 2-0 to Zerfus. So the long bus ride back last night, Alex Zerfus spent the majority of it working on an essay. He was working on an essay about poetry, and everybody else was sleeping. He was up on his laptop grinding away. So props to him. He said he finished it. It's due Saturday. And here comes the 2-0, and that's a check swing. Did he go? The appeal, he did not. So it is ball three. That's ball three. Some confusion on the scoreboard. But it is a 3-0 count now to Alex Zerfus, as he will hit here with the runner on first base and nobody out. Sinclair trying to avoid his first walk in today's outing. Here comes the pitch from the righty. Off the plate, no, catches the outside corner for strike one, and the 3-0 turns to 3-1 as McGee gets some signs and takes a lead off of first base. Team leader again, Eric Smelko with 14, but catcher Tyler Davis behind him with 12, and John Ponder up to 11 on the season, and then Cade McGee in that fourth spot with 10. We'll see if he'll take off at some point in this at-bat. The 3-1 home, he does take off. This one misses upstairs. It's ball four, and McGee will get his jersey dirty for no reason as he slides in safely on the walk. Runners on first and second, nobody out, and the cleanup man, JT Walden, gets another chance. So Walden tonight grounded out to third base. It was an RBI for him, and then he walked in a run in the second, so two RBIs today, and has increased his team lead in RBIs from 33 to 35, which is six more than anyone else on the squad. Excited to see him in the home run derby again. Pio's having the three games here against Souris Valley. Once that wraps up, immediately turn around and head to Casper for the All-Star break. As this one shot out into right field, fairly deep. Right fielder underneath it, though. Runner will tag. McGee scooting up to third base. Throw in is cut off, and he'll be in safely without a slide, so it'll be a productive out number one. Nice piece of hitting off the bat. Good contact from JT Walden, but right at Breedwell for out number one. So you preach, get him on, get him over, and get him in. The Pios got him on, the single and walk, and now Walden gets him over, puts runners on the corners with one away, and it's up to Jake English to get him in. Had the RBI single in his last at-bat, which was a rocket shot off of the starter, Morrow, and it bounced off of his backside into the 5-6 hole and was a hit. Runner's going to try and take second. Throw down to second is cut off, and the runner's going to come home to the plate. Throw beats him, and the tag does too. Cade McGee tries to steal a run, a first and third situational play, as Zerfus tries to steal second. But a nice play by the shortstop and second baseman Gunnar McGran as he cuts it off, fires home, and the throw's on the money for out number two. So Zerfus picks up the stolen bag. And two outs now for Sinclair on the mound. As it'll be a 0-1 count now to Jake English. The righty peaks to second, comes home. This one is a curveball and a beauty. Drops into the zone to move the count to 0-2. Two takes for English in this at-bat. But we'll have to protect on anything close. Pios, 7 runs on 5 hits today. Souris Valley, 2 runs on 5 hits. Here's the pitch home from Sinclair. 0-2 misses upstairs. Fastball moves it to 1-2. On English again, he's got 13 RBIs on the year and 19 games played. Pios have 4 players over 20. And then the one, JT Walden, over 30. Here comes a 1-2 home now from Sinclair as the righty looks to second and delivers the pitch. Another breaker. This one popped up right side, ranging towards the fence and sailing out of play to keep the count at 1-2. Currently the team leader, or not team leader, but league leader in RBIs this season is Austin Callahan, 55 for the Fremont Moo, and he was just drafted by the Cincinnati Reds in the recent MLB draft, the only expedition player active that was drafted. Here comes a 1-2 now from the righty Sinclair as this one's dribbled foul and Antonio Garcia can't make the play as the count stays at 1-2. Pios had the brother of Carson Ohl, Pearson Ohl, drafted by the Minnesota Twins, as well as Jack Sinclair, a former Pioneer, drafted out of the University of Central Florida. Bo Brewer for the Souris Valley sits in that second place role, 53 RBIs, but not playing tonight. Here comes the 1-2. This one dribbled off the end of the bat out towards short. Cooper fields and quickly fires on to first to beat English. For out number 3, the Pios leave a runner stranded at second after some nice defensive play. Throws out a run at the plate, and we head now to the 5th. The Pios on top, 7-2 here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB.
Join us for the best college baseball has to offer at the Expedition League All-Star Spectacular, presented by Hydrotex. Two nights of fun start July 19th with the Wyoming Medical Center Fan Fest, featuring Wyoming All-Star Girls softball, autograph sessions, a free kids clinic, and a home run derby presented by First Interstate Bank. July 20th features the Expedition League All-Star Game and an amazing fireworks show presented by Wyoms. Join us at Mike Lansing Field for the biggest sports event of the summer. Tickets available now at CasperHorseheads.com or by calling 233-4400.
Who is Hydrotex? Hydrotex manufactures and distributes over 300 different high-performance lubricants, including fuel conditioners, hydraulic and transmission fluid, and more. We've been helping customers improve their operations for more than 80 years with products made in the USA. We sell directly to customers and can even deliver right to your door to offer excellent service and value. Our products are made to exceedingly extend drain and grease intervals to reduce maintenance and labor costs to improve the budget. Whether you're in a factory, farm fleet, or like to go fast, Hydrotex is here to help. Visit your local Hydrotex dealer in person or online today.
Valley Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Top of the order up for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs after a ground ball double play ended that fourth inning. And got Caden Edwards out of a pretty tough jam, had a runner on second and first, only one away, but got the ground ball he needed. And now top of the order up for the third time tonight, as Edwards will try and work around Justin Cooper. To this point, Cooper is 2-for-2 with 2 singles and a stolen bag, but has been left stranded both times on base. Edwards quickly winds and delivers the first pitch of this fifth inning. It's shot out by the third baseline, but it goes foul, and the count moves to 0-1. Clay Cutter at third base tonight for the Pioneers. Again, has had some defensive struggles as of late, but looking to turn it around, and he's been getting it done at the plate. So it balances the two out. He had Three errors last night as this one's fouled back to the screen. The count moves to 0-2. And in the last game of the Badlands Big Stick Series, had three errors in that one at shortstop before he was defensively replaced by Mazzaferro. 0-2 home from Edwards. That one just misses. Caden Edwards wanted the strikeout, started to do his strikeout strut around the mound, and now we'll return to the rubber with a 1-2 count. Out of the windup, the lefty will deliver another. This time, the 1-2 is shot out towards short and into left field, base hit. Another hit for Justin Cooper and another leadoff single for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. 3-for-3 start for the shortstop tonight. And he has been on fire, producing 3 of the 6 hits for the Sabre Dogs tonight. Got to be frustrating on the mound for left-hander Caden Edwards after he thought he got out number one on the strikeout. Didn't get the call, and the next pitch was poked out into left field. A nice piece off the bat of Cooper as he'll be on first base. So Alan Greer comes up to the plate, lined out and flown out tonight. As the first pitch to him misses off the plate, it's ball one. For Greer, out of Chattanooga State Community College, a two-way player, outfielder, and pitcher at his community college. 370 average in the 17 games played in the COVID season. Watches this one catch the top of the zone and evens the count at 1-1. Jordan Williams in the on-deck circle. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts tonight. The only two strikeouts for Caden Edwards in this one. The lefty out of the stretch will once again come set and come home with a 1-1. That one misses upstairs in the count 2-1 after a quicker move to the plate. Usually he lifts that right leg a little bit higher, but a quick pitch to try and mess with the timing of the runner out there at first base. Cooper not moving, stays at first, but has another big lead here. About two and a half steps for Cooper off the first base bag, as here comes the 2-1. He'll take off, gets a great jump, throw down from English is not in time, picked by Kellen Rutz. But the second stolen base of the night for Justin Cooper moves him into scoring position. And that was a perfect jump for the man on first base. So Alan Greer will have a 3-1 count with a runner on second base and still nobody out. Caden Edwards will have to come home. Currently, Souris Valley out hitting the Pioneers 6-5, but trailing by 5. Edwards looks over to second and will now come home. The 3-1 popped up on the infield, shallow right on the dirt. Kellen Rutz coming out, and he'll drop it. Oh, no. Runner's going to advance up to third. And that is not Kellen Rutz's ball. That is Alex Zerfus all the way as it kept on tailing into shallow right field. Zerfus coming in on it, but Rutz called everybody off and tried to catch it falling backwards. It drops, and that's a big mistake for the Pioneers as it puts runners on the corners and nobody out.
Now batting from Minot State University, Jordan.
So there's the defense striking again for the Pioneers. It's been one of the areas they've struggled this year, as here comes an 0-0 from Edwards with the runners on the corners. That one off the plate, misses for ball one. Kellen Rutz dropping that pop-up. Trying to look at the fielding stats for the team right now. As here comes the 1-0 from Edwards, that one finds the zone and evens the count at 1-1. Rutz entered this game today, had 3 errors at second base, that now his 4th. And also 3 errors at short. This one now shot down the third baseline, but goes foul. Would have scored a run for sure. And now the count moves to 1-2. So Rutz 3 more errors at shortstop. That's now 7 on the year for him. Clay Cutter 4 at short. And at third base up there as well with 5 of them. Here comes a 1-2 now from Edwards. This one way off the plate, gets away. Cooper takes a step forward, but will have to hold up. A candy hop off the backstop. Bounces back to Jake English. It keeps Cooper at third, but moving up to second base on the wild pitch is Alan Greer. So it's a 2-2 count now to the three-hole hitter left fielder Jordan Williams. And Williams will try again. Edwards out of the stretch will deliver 2-2. Fastball upstairs popped up on the infield. Jake English coming out, but called off by Clay Cutter. Another pop-up. This time it's pulled in for out number one. Another best-case scenario for the man on the mound, Caden Edwards, after the runners stay put out there with one out. And now it'll be the cleanup man, Steven Moretto, to bat with the runners on second and third. Both of his at-bats tonight, a fly out to right and a line out to center, would have produced a run in this situation, as both were deep enough to score the runner on third, Cooper, without a throw. Had that been the situation. It is now, and we'll see what he can do. One out. And again, runners on second and third. Open base at first with Cullen Hannigan in the on-deck circle. Here's the first pitch from Edwards. That one misses off the plate. It's ball one. So it's now 81 pitches for the man on the mound, Edwards, as he tries to escape this fifth. He needs two more outs to do so. Here comes the 1-0 now from the man out of Duluth, Minnesota. This one swung on, roped down the third baseline again, but foul. That's the third or fourth time tonight we've seen a Sabre dog square up a ball but be early on it and send it just foul to the left of the third base bag, and it evens the count at 1-1. Caden Edwards again, a freshman at North Dakota State with the Bison, is the sixth best pitcher, left-handed pitcher in Minnesota out of high school at Duluth East High School, and also a star quarterback there. Here comes a 1-1 now from Edwards. Swung on and missed. Good fastball upstairs, and he's ahead now 1-2, looking for a big out number two. Steven Moretto for the Sabre Dogs. He sits entering today a .344 average in 17 games. 14 strikeouts. And Edwards trying to make that 15 for out number two. The lefty sets, quick pitches home. This one called, strike three. Fastball inside corner gets the call and sits down Moretto for a big out number two. Big pitch from Edwards in a big situation as the runners remain on second and third now for the Sabre Dogs, and it's up to Cullen Hannigan to extend the inning. He singled and scored as part of the two-run home run in the second, but flew out to right in his other at-bat. And Edwards trying to work out of a tough jam in this one after a leadoff single and error put the first two runners on. That one misses upstairs. It's ball one. Runners were on second and third with nobody out, and now they remain at second and third, two outs for Hannigan out of Rice University. The Owls playing in the CUSA Conference, as that one just misses off the plate in the count 2-0. CUSA, two really good teams out of the CUSA this year. It was UNC Charlotte and Florida Atlantic. Dalton Frank out of FAU, as it's a 2-0 count now from Caden Edwards, and he tries to fight back in the at-bat. Here comes the pitch from the lefty. That one gets away, and it's going to allow a run to score, and it won't be a perfect execution escaping the jam, as one run will cross the plate on the wild pitch. The count goes to 3-0, and scooting up to third now is Alan Greer. Second wild pitch of the inning for Caden Edwards allows the third run to score for the Sabre Dogs, as it's a 7-3 ball game now. Hannigan a 3-0 count. Edwards will come home. This one misses off the plate. It's a four-pitch walk, and it'll put runners on the corners now. One out for Drew Miller, the home run hitter at the plate, and a big at-bat to come. We'll see if there will be a visit to the mound Looks like not. Edwards will remain out there on the rubber, and the left-handed D.H. Miller comes back up to the plate. The two-run home run in the second inning were the first two runs of the game and the only runs for the Sabre Dogs until that wild pitch. And then a walk for Miller in four pitches his last at bat. Watches this one run inside and hit him. That one brushed the elbow guard is what it looked like, and it'll be a hit-by-pitch. Kiefer is going to head out to the mound, the pitching coach for the Pioneers, after the hit-by-pitch. And the base is loaded with two outs. Edwards will still have to look for out number three. So Ethan Moore comes up to the plate. He's flown out to right, popped up to first in his two at-bats. And the Pios one pitch away from getting out of this inning. A short conversation from Trent Kiefer out there, trying to calm down his starter and left-hander Caden Edwards, who now stands at 90 pitches trying to get out of this fifth inning. Has allowed three earned runs tonight. On the two-run home run and that wild pitch, the 0-0 now to Ethan Moore. That one swung on, fouled back, and Moore starts behind in the count 0-1. Ethan Moore playing at Kent State University before transferring to Murray State in the 2021 season. Out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, watches this one, swings at it upstairs, that one way out of the zone, and the chase helps out the man on the mound. He's ahead 0-2. Out of the windup with the bases loaded, Edwards comes home with an 0-2. The pitch swung on, dribbled out toward short. Mazzaferro Fields will go the long way to first, and it is in time for out number three. Caden Edwards escapes this fifth inning with minimal damage, does allow a run, but leaves the bases loaded here in this top of the fifth as the Pios head to the bottom half with a 7-3 lead here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Why bank at a local community bank? When you choose a local community bank, you keep money in our local economy. That money helps support local jobs, schools, and businesses. Money that helps fund a stronger and prosperous community for us all to enjoy and live in. At Platte Valley Bank, we are here to help build and support the community we love being a part of. We believe that together, we can make great things happen. Platte Valley Bank.
Player, and here it comes. Shot high out to the left side. Left fielder, long way to go, trying to track it down towards the wall. It keeps on going, and that'll go foul as Jordan Williams took a strange route to that ball. He came on a line, and then once he got to the spot, had to move backwards and watched it fall behind his head. So Clay Cutter gets another life as the count moves to 0-1. Cutter, 5 for 14 with a pair of RBIs, pair of runs last series. And he was another candidate to replace Dalton Frank for the Pioneers in the All-Star game. That one misses off the plate to even the count at 1-1. Sits at a .291 average with 22 RBIs. A home run and 6 doubles for him in 34 games. And he has carried over his fantastic freshman season at Iowa Western here with the Pioneers. 1-1 home. That one misses off the plate. The count now moves to 2-1. But he will be missed as he heads out on Monday. This is his last series with the Pioneers after Iowa Western shutting down Derek Brown and Clay Cutter, both of them returning home before the season. As here comes the 1-1. Swung on, poked out into shallow right field, and it'll drop in, base hit. Nice hitting from Clay Cutter as he throws the barrel out there, and he gets enough of it to push it out into right field for a leadoff single, and he opens up the bottom of the fifth on base. Time for some Paul Reed in-game stats. Paul Reed Construction and Supply has been in business for over 35 years. Headquartered in Garing, Nebraska, the company provides an array of services ranging from commercial and industrial building construction to heavy highway earthwork and installation of underground utilities, as well as the Rock Pile Division, service and equipment, Paul Reed Construction on 10th Street. In Garing, Nate Schwartz 0 for 2 today, a strikeout and a flyout, and 2 for 7 in the last series against the Spuds. Looking to add his first hit here, watches this one miss up and in, it's ball one. Struck out looking to end the first and then flew out to left to end the second. And bats here in this fifth inning as Sinclair looks for out number one. Cutter a nice lead over there at first base as the righty will deliver. Cutter takes off. This one swung on, dribbled out towards third. No chance at two as Cutter beats it. The throw on to first base is in time, and it will be out number one. So Nate Schwartz 0 for 3 now today as he returns to the dugout, and Kellen Rutz comes up to the plate for the third time. Walked and scored in his first plate appearance and then grounded out to the first baseman to open that third inning. In the first batter faced for Shane Sinclair, this will be the second at bat for Kellen Rutz against him as he tries to adjust at the plate. One out and a runner in scoring position is Clay Cutter. Yeah, Sinclair will look over to second and come home with an 0-0. That one misses high and away, and the count now 1-0 on Kellen Rutz. He has been on a tear of drawing walks recently. 5 walks in the last series and already a walk tonight as he currently sits at 14 walks on the season. Io's pretty decent in drawing the walk overall, and then Cade McGee 16 more than anybody else on the team as that one catches the top of the zone for strike one. Is the outlier there. Io is not a team that hit a ton of home runs. Have 3 tied for the team lead with only 3 home runs. As here comes a 1-1 now from Sinclair, still looking home, awaiting a sign, and will finally get it as he comes set and will deliver. Cutter dancing out there at second. No one holding him on. He'll come home. This one, whoa, sails away, skips out of the glove of the catcher, and Cutter's going to try and skip up to third, and he will. Nice base running from Clay Cutter as it moves him 90 feet from the plate with one out, as that one might go as a passed ball against catcher Cullen Hannigan in and out of his glove, as Rutz will now see a 2-1. Chance for him to drive in some runs. Again, the Pioneers currently sit the 4th lowest home run total in the league with 20, actually tied for the 3rd lowest with the Canyon County Spuds. Only the Horseheads and the Hastings Sodbusters below them. That's a breaking ball from Sinclair. Not sure where it misses, but it will miss, and it'll count as a ball. 3-1 count now to Kellen Rutz. Yeah. Righty Sinclair brings home a 3-1 to Rutz. This one catches the inside corner. That's twice this at bat. Kellen Rutz has tried to spin out of the way of pitches that were over the plate, trying to win that ball call. Instead, both went as strikes, and it's a 3-2 count now to the second baseman. And he'll try and work the full count to drive in Clay Cutter on third base. Sinclair sighs and comes home. The pitch swung on and shot out towards second. It'll do a job as the second baseman fires to first. It sends the first baseman Ethan Moore up the line, but he makes a nice play and recovers for out number two. But the ground out does bring in a run for the Pioneers as Clay Cutter scores, and it's now an 8-3 ball game here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. So nobody on and two away now for Mazzaferro, who's 0-1 on the day. Was hit by a pitch, came around to score, and then a fly out to right field. That went a long way, tracked down by Jared Breedwell at the track, just shy of that right field wall as Mazzaferro shows some opposite field power. That one misses upstairs, and ducking out of the way is Mazzaferro for ball one. And he'll start ahead in the count. Pio's really not impressing league-wise in any offensive categories. Middle of the pack in pretty much everything as that curveball finds the zone. The count evens up at 1-1. Pioneers this season fourth in the league in runs with 335. And comes with a territory of being 31-12 through the first 43 games. As here comes a 1-1. Swung on, shot out into left center field. Center fielder coming over, but he can't get to it. It'll drop in front of him. Mazzaferro hard 90. Will round first, but pull up at the first base bag and be content with the two-out single. His first hit of the game brings up the top of the order with two away, and Smelko gets another chance to hit. Pioneers as a team are batting .293 on the year. Only three teams batting over .300. It's the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs, the Spearfish Sasquatch, and the Fremont Moo. All of those teams capable of making the playoffs. Souris Valley currently leading the way in the Lewis division. Fremont, Sioux Falls are neck and neck in the Clark division as for this start. Mazzaferro tries to take second. Throw down is up the line. And it will be a stolen bag. Misses the bag, the throw does, rather. Not up the line. But Mazzaferro adds another stolen base, moves himself into scoring position, and it's a 1-0 count to Eric Smelko with another run 180 feet from the plate. Smelko 1-for-2 today, a single and a run, a sack bunt, and then a fly out to right field. As center fielder Alan Greer playing to the left of the second base bag. This one shot out to the right side. Second baseman fields it on the run. The throw on to first is away from the first baseman. And another run will come home to score. Eric Smelko will reach. After shooting that one to the right side, Gunnar McGran could not make the play. It's another error. And it allows another run to cross this inning as the Pios now lead 9-3. So McGran recorded the last out on the Kellen Rutz ground out, but that throw was up the line. First baseman Ethan Moore had to leap off the bag, kept his foot on the bag, and made a nice play to reel it in for out number two. That time, the throw missed him by a good margin, skipped underneath the glove of Ethan Moore, and allowed the run to come home. Smelko will try and take off here, but swinging is Cade McGee, shoots it foul, and the count goes to 0-1. As Eric Smelko returns to the first base bag. So that is now the second unearned run tonight for the Pioneers. As they lead 9-3 here in Garing, Nebraska. Cade McGee trying to add to it. Here's an 0-1 now from Sinclair. Pickoff to first base. Smelko dives back in safely. Sinclair again entering into the third inning, went 1-2-3, left some runners stranded in the fourth, but a pair of singles as well as an error and a pass ball have allowed two runs to score this inning, and the Pios have jumped out to their six-run lead. Here comes another home from Sinclair. No, another pickoff and a closer play over to Eric Smelko, but out of the glove of Ethan Moore, allows Smelko to dive back in safely. Again, team leader already taken off once in this at-bat. Has 14 stolen bags in 19 attempts this year. As here comes an 0-1. He'll take off again. That one, nice pitch. And nice throw down to second. Beats him by a mile. Nice throw from Cullen Hannigan as the fastball on the outer half is not the pitch you want to run on. Basically a pitch out. Guns down Eric Smelko. His sixth caught stealing of the year is out number three. And we head to the top of the sixth inning. Pios add two more on the two hits, error, and a pass ball. And have a 9-3 six-run lead as we head to the sixth inning. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
At Wells Fargo Advisors, we've built our firm around a deep respect for planning. Our commitment to helping you plan effectively, invest wisely, and map a realistic course to your future is nowhere more evident than our Envision planning process. Put the process to work for you. We'll be with you every step of the way. For more information, call Ryan Windhorst, Senior Vice President of Investments, today at 632-7561. That's 632-7561.
Hydrotex Lubrication is an industry leader in high-performance motor oils, greases, and fuel improvers. Hydrotex's main priorities are to provide the best products and the most efficient and reliable service to fit the customer's application needs. For more information on how Hydrotex can help you, call Phil and Nick at 308-635-8162. Stop into our new showroom at 2860 Holiday Park Drive in Gearing and see the products and services they offer, as well as purchase any products that you need.
Drive happy this summer with auto insurance from J.G. Elliott. Hi, I'm Lila Nash, and when you choose J.G. Elliott as your auto insurance provider, you'll get a variety of options and deductibles, including car rental coverage and customized equipment coverage, so you can get on the road without the worry. If a new boat, motorcycle, RV, or ATV is part of your summer plan, we can insure that too. Plus, you can bundle your vehicle and home insurance to save even more. J.G. Elliott has insurance coverage for all your summer adventures. J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Welcome back as we're here for the top of the sixth inning. This game moving along nicely as Souris Valley will come up to the plate here in the top of the sixth. Gunnar McGran will lead things off and Caden Edwards remains on the mound. First pitch home in there for strike one as he starts ahead on the second baseman. Here comes an 0-1. This one swung on, fouled off high to the left side, and the count moves to 0-2. So I don't know if it was picked up on the camera, but in between innings, we had the hot dog toss, a promotional thing done at the end of every fifth inning here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. As here comes an 0-2 from Edwards. That one misses. And John Ponder out of the lineup tonight, helping toss out the hot dogs. Made some eye contact with me, and I opened up the window, he tossed it up here, and made a play. So proud of myself after that one, and I have a hot dog as this one shot out into right field, and it'll be a leadoff single here in the top of the sixth. McGran, a hard round of first, but will hold up there, and a leadoff single for him opens up this sixth inning as the nine-hole hitter Jared Breedwell comes to the plate with nobody out. So Breedwell tonight, the right fielder, 0-for-2, has flown out to center and then grounded into the inning ending 6-4-3 double play in the fourth. I'm sure Edwards wouldn't mind one here. First pitch home, misses high and away, it's ball one. As that is now pitch number 98 for Edwards on the mound. I'm sure he does not have much left as the Pioneers bullpen already has the door open. As here comes the 1-0 now from the lefty. Pickoff to first base, and it gets away. Caden McGee can't make the play, and they'll get scoot up to second. McGran will round second and take off for third. This one still struggled with in the outfield, and the throw in now back to the pitcher. An error on the pickoff moves a runner to third base with nobody out, and not what Caden Edwards wanted on the mound.
Go,
Looked like he was trying to juke out the runner, looking at the plate as he quickly winds and delivers. This one swung on and missed. It's strike one to Jared Breedwell. It's a 1-1 count now to the nine-hole hitter. As Edwards will quickly come home with another 0-1. No, that one misses low. It was a 1-1, so it now is 2-1 on the right-handed hitter and right fielder. Good arms in the outfield, Walden, Smelko, and Zerfus on a fly ball as this one's fouled away out to the right side, and the count will move to 2-2. Jared Breedwell digs back into the box in a 2-2 count. And Edwards quickly winds and delivers again. This one home is swung on, shot out into center field. Smelko underneath it. We'll see if the runner tags. Coming in on it, fields and fires home. It's a good throw all the way to the plate, but not in time, as sliding in safely is the fourth run of the game for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs in the form of second baseman Gunnar McGran. And he'll cross the plate on out number one. Nice throw from Smelko out there in center. As he threw a laser beam to the plate, but again, the speed of McGrand's second baseman beat the throw as that one misses high and away for ball one on Justin Cooper, who tonight is 3-for-3, two stolen bags and a run. Watches this one miss in, and it's a 2-0 count now to the shortstop tonight. Edwards now over the 100 pitch count as that one misses the spot, and the count 3-0. As we'll see if he will get through this batter. I'm sure if he lets him on, it might be his last. 3-0 now from the lefty. That one finds the zone, and the count moves to 3-1. Edwards speeding on the mound as he quickly out of the windup brings a 3-1. That one catches the top of the zone, and the count runs full now, 3-2. Cooper was ready to walk down to first base with his first walk of the night. Instead, it's called strike two. And we'll have a full count pitch. Edwards quickly delivers again. This one shot out towards short, under the glove of the third baseman, but fielded on the backhand. Throw to first, not in time. Cooper beats it out, but that was an unbelievable play by Jared Mazzaferro, as he couldn't even see the ball. Cutter tried to cut it off, and it was under the glove. Mazzaferro on the backhand in the deep hole. Fires on to first, but Cooper's speed beats it out. It's an infield single with one away. So make it a 4-for-4 day for Justin Cooper, as he leads off of first base again, looking for his third stolen base of the night. Won't go here, and that one crosses the plate for strike one on Alan Greer, tonight's beer batter. He's 0-for-3, reached on an error, lined out, and flied out tonight. As he'll see another now from the lefty, Edwards. Looks over to first, looks home, back to first, and delivers home. That one tipped back to the screen, and the count moves to 0-2. Beer batter of the night down to a two-strike count, and Edwards looking for out number two here in this sixth inning. Pios a 9-4 lead at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. As the lefty Edwards out of the stretch, will not come home. Time is called, and Greer steps out, takes a couple practice swings before returning to the batter's box. Outfielder out of Chattanooga State Community College awaits the 0-2 from Edwards. Fastball outer half misses, and the count now goes to 1-2. Edwards still ahead, and can continue to throw a chase pitch if need be. As the fans wanting the strikeout for the discounted beer tonight. Here comes a 1-2 now from the right, or lefty. Curveball stays outside, and the count now goes to 2-2. Two count. Edwards looks over to first base, looks home, and will come home yet again. The pitch swung on and missed. Down on strikes is Alan Greer, and the beer batter strikes out tonight, which will bring a flood of people to the beer stands for some discounted drinks. That is the fourth strikeout of the evening for Caden Edwards, as he's now one out away from getting out of this sixth inning and likely ending his night with the six innings of work. He will face Jordan Williams out of Minot State. He's 0 for 3 today, a pop-up and a pair of strikeouts as the first pitch to him misses for ball one. It's 113 pitches for Edwards here as that pitch count continues to rise. This one fouled back. Is that strike number one? 1-1 count on the right-handed hitting left fielder. Again, has been stellar this year. A 305 average at Minot State and a good average with the Sabre Dogs as well. As this one misses off the plate, the count goes to 2-1. Williams has hit 361 in his 17 games here, but not the case right now as he's 0-for-3 in this one. The lefty with a 2-1 count, Cooper still on first base, takes his lead, and the pitch will come home. That one swung on, chopped foul out to the third base side, and the count now goes 2-2. Edwards looking for back-to-back strikeouts to end his night. With his four strikeouts tonight, he is now at 48 on the year. Looking for number 49, he'll bring home a 2-2. Swung on, skied up on the infield. Kellen Rutz comes over, calls everybody off. Ranging back into the outfield, Grassy makes the play for out number three. Caden Edwards allows a run to come home in this sixth inning, but exits with a five-run lead as his day is likely done, and it was a good one. A 9-4 lead for the Pioneers as they come to the plate in the bottom of the sixth inning. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato Olay's, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said,
"Get your hands off my burrito."
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast. Only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations on Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Play ball!
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Pios coming to the plate here. It's the bottom of the sixth inning at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. And the Pioneers lead 9-4. Shane Sinclair remains in the game for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs, and he's done a great job out of relief as he's given up two runs since the starter exited after the second. The teams have been level at 2-2, but the Pios lead by 5 after scoring 7 off the starter. That one misses off the plate, and the count goes to 1-0 on Cade McGee. Two-hole hitter tonight is 2-for-2, two singles, a walk, and a pair of runs. Looking to reach base yet again in this one as Sinclair comes set and delivers the 1-0. Curveball and a good one. That one drops into the zone to even the count at 1-1 on McGee. Again, among the leaders in walks this year in all of the Expedition League. The league leader is Ryan Bachman. He's got 37. Cade McGee now at 36. Watches this one miss off the plate, and the count goes to 2-1. Cardoso at 37 as well with the Pier Trappers, who just came off a stellar pitching performance last night. A no-hitter, first of the year in the Expedition League. As the 2-1 home fouled off to the right side, and the count now evens up at 2-2. Again, the Trappers had a fantastic outing last night. It was Fisher Rausch who threw 9 innings, no hits, no earned runs, and 10 strikeouts in a stellar outing. Probably the best of the year in the Expedition League. This one popped up shallow right field. Coming in is the right fielder, and losing a hat is Breedwell, but he catches it on the run for out number one. As that'll be the first out here in this bottom of the sixth inning, and we'll bring up Alex Zerfus. So looking at some of the scores around the league today, the Badlands Big Sticks up big in Dickinson, 9-1 over the Canyon County Spuds after the Spuds had to drive out there last night.
Now at bat from Gonzaga University,
sympathizing with them
Alex
after
Zerfus.
The Pioneers and myself had to come home from Caldwell, Idaho last night. That one cuts inside, misses the spot, though, and the count 1-0. Hastings Sodbusters on top of the Casper Horseheads at home, 10-6 in that one. Mining City Tommyknockers in a close one with a Sasquatch, 5-4 there on top on the road. The Sioux Falls Sunfish took down the Fremont Moo as this one's dribbled out towards third, hopped into the glove of the third baseman, throw on to first in the dirt, and gets away from the first baseman. Zerfus will return to the first base bag, and yet another error for Souris Valley. That is now their third.
Roll day.
And it'll go to third baseman Steven Moretto to put Zerfus on first base. So JT Walden comes up to the plate. He's got a pair of RBIs and is currently 0-2 on the day. Looking for his first hit. Did smoke a ball out to right field, right at the right fielder, Jared Breedwell, though.
Next up at bat for your Pios from Gonzaga University, JT Walden.
Now Sinclair with one out, runner on first base, will come home again. Righty size and out of the stretch delivers. Misses inside, it's ball one. And Walden will start ahead. The Sioux Falls Sunfish again on top of the Fremont Moo, 3-1 in a quick game, a 2.5-hour game at Karis Park in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Sioux Falls has been a great story this second half. After a rough first half, they are now tied for first in the Clark Division in the second half through the first 15 games. This one catches the top of the zone and evens the count at 1-1. On JT Walden. Walker Bullington has turned his squad around there in Sioux Falls as their win over Fremont today has pushed them into that first place tie. Both teams now at 11-4 on the season, or on the second half rather. As here comes a 1-1, no pickoff to first base, forces Zerfus to dive back in safely. And then the Wheat City Whiskey Jacks up 12-2 on the Pure Trappers in Kraft Field. After the Trappers no-hit them last night. So a nice bounce-back response. Sometimes you get no hits, sometimes you put up 12 runs. And that's especially the storyline in this Expedition League. Runner takes off here. This one now shot out into left field, and it'll drop in base hit. Zerfus rounds second and gets the wave from his head coach. He's going to come home. Throw in is to second, cut off, and no throw to the plate. It's an RBI double for JT Walden, his third of the game, and the Pios have put up their 10th. It's now 10-4. Hit and run executed to perfection once again as center fielder Alan Greer playing to the left of the second base bag from his point of view, right from our point of view. And that one shot into the left center gap, so he had a longer way to run. And watch that one fall in the gap. Zerfus rounding second when that ball dropped. Got the wave from his coach around third, and the throw in was to second as Walden slid in safely.
English.
As that's the eighth Pioneers hit and the 10th Pioneers run, they now lead by six and get that run back, which was scored in the top half. First pitch to Jake English here in the dirt, blocked for ball one. English will scramble, Walden will scramble back to second after taking a step towards the third base bag initially. Alex Zerfus has a good arm in the outfield, has been squaring balls up at the plate, and he is a sneaky good base runner as he has been aggressive on the base paths this year and stolen a few runs. As that one scoots away, Walden again takes a step towards third, but will have to scramble back, and the count goes to 2-0. It was one of the games earlier in the season towards Zerfus's first few series of the year. I believe it might have been Spearfish. But either way, he was on second base, runners on second and third, on a routine ground ball to first. A routine ground ball, Zerfus scored from second base. Speedy and smart base runner as this one misses the plate. The count now 3-0 to Jake English, who will tell you he's as quick as can be. Antonio Garcia would disagree as the catcher is perfect on a 4-for-4 for stolen bases this year. He'll have a 3-0 pitch now from the righty. That one swung on, roped out into left field, and that's going to be extra bases. JT Walden will score. English takes off for second, fielded off the wall. The throw in is cut off, and it's back-to-back RBI doubles from the Pioneers. JT Walden and Jake English now come through, and it's 11-4 lead here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Still only one out here in the bottom of the sixth inning, and action continuing in the bullpen for the Sabre Dogs. As that is now the fourth run allowed for the man on the mound, Shane Sinclair, since entering in the third. First pitch now to Clay Cutter, misses off the plate, and it's ball one. Cutter is 1-for-2 on the day. Yeah, reached on an error in his first at bat. Had the sacked fly in the second, which brought across a run, and then singled and scored in the fifth with a chance to drive in another with English on second base. Here comes the 1-0. That one cuts inside and gets the call. It moves the count to 1-1, and English hops out of the way unhappy with the call, but returns to the batter's box and adjusts to see a 1-1 pitch now. A 1-1 home. This one, a heavy hack from Clay Cutter, but he comes up empty and moves the count to 1-2 for Sinclair on the mound. He has gone 29.1 innings of work entering tonight. And a 7.05 ERA, only holding teams scoreless in outings three times in his 11 this year. This one shot out to the right side and pulled in by the first baseman, Ethan Moore. That one, a looping line drive out to the right side, just right of the first base bag. And Ethan Moore, jogging over there, reached his glove out and kind of snow-coned it. That'll be a big out number two. English remains on second, and Cutter returns to the dugout.
Now at bat from Maloney Junior College, Nate Schwartz.
Schwartz 0-for-3 tonight, looking for a chance to drive in English on second base. The first pitch to him from Sinclair misses low and away. It's ball one. This season for Nate Schwartz has been a .242 start in 10 games. Eight total hits, but none of them going for extra bases. Still looking for his first extra base knock of the year, and skies this one down the left side. That one might have had extra base power, but it goes so far foul that it'll exit the stadium, probably land in the street outside the stadium, and the count evens up at 1-1. Schwartz also 15 strikeouts in the 10 games played to this point. As this curveball just misses inside, and the count now favors Schwartz 2-1. Those 15 strikeouts in 10 games, the highest in a low amount. Everyone in front of him has played at least 20 games. Smelko, with 36 games under his belt, only has 11 strikeouts this season and has been fantastic. As that one catches the outside corner, the count evens up at 2-2. And he's had 160 at bat to Schwartz's 33 with less strikeouts. So the DH tonight out of Ohlone Junior College, trying to avoid going down on strikes here, has a 2-2 count, two away, and the runner on second. Pitch home. Misses off the plate, and the count goes full now, 3-2. Catcher at Ohlone out of Lay High School in California. Teammate of Jared Mazzaferro, who sits in the hole right now at Ohlone. Schwartz will call time before the full count pitch can come home. And he'll return to the batter's box refreshed and regrouped, ready to see another. Pios have put up two runs in this inning. They lead 11-4 here on the West Coast scoreboard, and Schwartz trying to add to it. Here comes a 3-2. Up and in, misses ball four, and Schwartz draws the walk to extend the inning. Runners on first and second now, and Kellen Rutz will get another turn at the plate with two away as Sinclair returns to the mound. And action in the Souris Valley bullpen is sure to wrap up shortly. So three RBIs today for JT Walden, who has the team lead. Two more from Alex Zerfus, and two from Jake English, as now a visit to the mound. We'll see if Sinclair will stay in the game as the action continues in the bullpen. It might just be a conversation to try and get that reliever warming up. So Jake English on second, Nate Schwartz on first, as the conversation continues. Home plate umpire will head out there to break it up. And Kellen Rutz will see his first of the inning. Walked and scored in the second, and then grounded out to first in his first at-bat against Sinclair before grounding out to second and bringing home a run in his second at-bat against Sinclair. Trying to pick up his first hit against the righty here from the left side. As Sinclair will stay in the game and pitch to another Pios hitter. Pios, 9 hits, 11 runs tonight to Souris Valley's 4 runs on 8 hits. As I'm sure the Pioneers will have a new arm when they come back for the top of the 7th. Sinclair looks to second and comes home. First pitch to Rutz. He swings right through an icebreaker for strike one. Rutz out of Yakima Valley Community College. And he has had a good season so far with the Pioneers. Been pretty good defensively and a .228 average, but his 14 walks have increased his on-base percentage to a pretty good rate. The next home, that one just misses, and the count will even up at 1-1. Rutz out of Kennewick, Washington, was a standout wide receiver at Kamiakin High School. As well as a dominant second baseman. Here comes the 1-1. Watches this one cut, but too far low. As the count favors him now, 2-1. As the pitch count continues to rise for the righty on the mound, he is up now at 76 pitches to this point. All out of relief. Here comes another. This one, another breaker that can't cut into that outside corner. And it's a 3-1 count now to Kellen Rutz. I'm sure this will probably be Sinclair's last batter, whether he gets the out or allows him to reach. I got a feeling that Souris Valley will head to the bullpen and replace him either way, with Mazzaferro in the on-deck circle. And it would load the bases with a walk. 3-1 now to the left-handed hitting second baseman as Sinclair comes home. This one swung on, blooped out into left center field. Center fielder coming over, and it's going to drop in, base hit. Another run will score as Schwartz will pull into third base, and Rutz will get the second. It's an RBI double, the third RBI double of the inning It extends the score to 12-4, and Mazzaferro comes up to the plate to try and keep the line moving after some good two-out hitting. So English crosses the plate. Scooting up to third base is Nate Schwartz. And that'll bring a visit to the mound and end the day for the right-hander Shane Sinclair. He had a pretty good day out of the pen after replacing Morrow, who allowed 7 runs and bridged it over as far as he could, but the wheels falling off here in the sixth after he's allowed 3 runs on an error, 3 RBI doubles, and a walk. And there'll be a new arm into the game to try and find the third out of this bottom of the sixth inning. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, Jared Mazzaferro will hit with 2 away and runners on second and third. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Rainbow!
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
So back here for the bottom of the sixth inning as Mazzaferro will hit here with the runners on second and third following the RBI double from Kellen Rutz. And a new arm will be into the game for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. It's number 31, Declan Harper out of Miles City Community College. The righty will pitch to Mazzaferro to get us going here in this bottom of the sixth inning. Has a 1-1 record on the season with a 7.36 ERA in 6 games, all of them out of relief. 7.1 total innings of work, 6 strikeouts to 10 walks, trying to hone in his command here as he will pitch to the 9-hole hitter Mazzaferro. His last outing against the Badlands Big Sticks, that was July 14th. He got the win in that 3-1 ball game after going 2 innings out of relief without allowing a hit. Did walk 4 batters. But did not allow a run. And I'm sure his Souris Valley teammates are expecting a similar outing here as they trail by 8. And Mazzaferro trying to bring home a couple more. Shortstop out of Ohlone Junior College. Last series was 5-for-12. He's been hit by a pitch, flown out, and single tonight. Also has a pair of runs. As he'll see the first pitch home. Harper. Out of the stretch, looks over to third, now comes home. That one misses low and away, and the at-bat to Mazzaferro is underway as he starts ahead 0-1. Harper again out of Miles City Community College. We've seen a couple of those guys throughout the Expedition League this season. First time the Pios have seen the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs this year in a matchup of the two top teams in the league. As that one misses for ball two. Pios enter tonight 43 games, 31-12 record to the Sabre Dogs, 31-14 rate. As the Pios currently sit at 8-4 in the second half, a couple games back, but have already clinched that playoff spot, as have the Sabre Dogs. This one home, swung on and missed. Heavy hack from Jared Mazzaferro. He comes up empty, though, and the count now moves to 2-1. Eric Smoko sits in the on-deck circle after the Taco John's player of the game Earned those honors last night. 3 for 5, a run, and 2 RBIs, including the 2 RBI single, which put his team in front in the eighth. A 4-run eighth inning last night gave the Pioneers that 8-6 win. 14 hits for him in that one, already 10 tonight. This one struck foul out to the right side, and the count will even up at 2-2. So deuces wild here, 2-2 count, 2 away, 2 on base for the Pios as they look to extend their 12-4 lead. 3 runs already in this inning, and 2 runs in that bottom of the fifth. Mazzaferro digs in, and Declan Harper stares him down out of the stretch. The righty will come set, look over to second, now to third, now to the plate. The pitch swung on and missed. Mazzaferro goes down on strikes, and the Pios leave a couple of runners stranded, but they add 3 runs to their lead here in this bottom of the sixth inning on 3 RBI doubles from the bats of the Pioneers. They take the field for the top of the seventh. Coming up next, after these quick messages, you're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
I'm Jennifer Yurdialis, and I want to help you get into your first home. As a loan officer with Castle & Cook Mortgage, your local direct lender, I offer conventional financing as well as VA, FHA, and USDA home loans. I keep every step simple and straightforward so you can focus on finding your American dream. Call me today at 308-220-0503 for a free consultation.
Jennifer Yurdialis, NMLS ID 1059626. Not all who apply will qualify. Equal housing lender. Castle & Cook Mortgage, LLC, NMLS ID 125.
A thunderstorm or tornado doesn't have to last long to wreak havoc. Once the storm has passed, it doesn't mean the danger has. There could be a variety of deadly hazards left by the storm, like a downed power line. There's no way to tell if a power line is energized and potentially deadly. A downed power line does not have to be arcing or smoking to kill you. Stay away from it. Keep others away and call 911. For more information on how to be safe during and after severe weather, go to safeelectricity.org. Brought to you by Chimney Rock and Roosevelt Public Power Districts.
Your Touchstone Energy Partners.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
So we're back for the top of the seventh inning. New arm into the game as Caden Edwards' day is done, but he finished with a pretty good 6 innings of work. 4 strikeouts for him and only allowing the 4 runs. Exits with a pretty large lead, 12-4, the Pios out in front as Paul Pandoro enters into the game for the Pioneers out of Western Nebraska Community College. And he'll play in the fall at Pittsburgh Community College after transferring, but he has been phenomenal on the mound out of relief this year for the Western Nebraska Pioneers. 6 outings for him, 12.1 innings, a 2-0 record, and a 2.18 ERA. Starts ahead on Steven Moretto here, the third baseman, 0-1. Moretto sits 0-3 today, a flyout, a lineout, and a strikeout, all against Caden Edwards, and Pandoro trying to extend that trend. Here's the 0-1. Shot out into center field fairly deep. Long way to run for Smelko. Back towards the wall. He'll turn up and watch it fly. A solo home run off the bat of Steven Moretto. Second home run of the day for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. And Pandoro opens up his outing with a solo shot to cut the deficit to 7. It's now 12-5. That one squared up off the bat of Moretto. He was looking for it and got it. And Smelko took off. He's got great range out there in center field, but not good enough to catch one over the fence as that one sailed over the batter's eye for the solo home run. That's now the third straight inning that the Sabre Dogs have pushed across a run, and it is a 12-5 ball game as Pandoro will try and bounce back against Hannigan. This one shot off, spun off the end of the bat towards Kellen Rutz at second, and he'll fire on to first for out number one. It's a nice bounce back at bat for Paul Pandoro after allowing the solo home run. That's the first home run Pandoro's given up all year, as he hasn't really given up a lot of runs. The 12.1 innings of work four saves for him, 14 Ks, six walks. And a win in his last outing against the Badlands Big Sticks after going 2.2 in relief. Three strikeouts for him there in the 10 batters that he faced. And he gets ahead of another home run hitter tonight, Drew Miller, who had the two-run homer, which opened the scoring for the Sabre Dogs in the second. He falls behind 0-1. Pandoro pumps and winds to deliver an 0-1. That one sails up too high to even the count at one apiece. As the DH has hit that two-run home run, walked, and then been hit by a pitch. All of those against lefty Caden Edwards. As Pandoro tries again, 1-1. This one struck out into shallow center. Coming over is the shortstop, and Mazzaferro, a nice sliding grab in that 4-6 hole to make a nice play for out number two. And you can see why his glove has been so good for the Pioneers. Earned a gold glove at Ohlone Junior College this year for the conference. Big honors for him as he is looking to do bright things out of junior college. He talks with some schools right now. And he has been fantastic for this Pioneer squad. First pitch now to the seven-hole hitter, Ethan Moore. That one catches the outside corner, strike one. Moore 0 for 3 tonight with a flyout, pop-up, and ground out. As Pandoro's 0-1, that one same spot, same result. 0-2 count after two quick fastballs. And wasting no time, he toes the rubber and is ready to come home again. Pandoro stares home, nods, and delivers. 0-2 pitch. Fastball upstairs. Ducking out of the way is Ethan Moore. And the count now goes to 1-2. Ethan Moore out of Murray State College with the Aggies. Previously playing at Kent State University before transferring. And the Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania native will see a 1-2. This one shot out towards second once again. Kellen Rutz on the run, fields and fires in time for out number three. So Paul Pandoro bounces back. A leadoff solo home run off the bat of Moretto cuts it to 12-5. But 1-2-3 after that as the Pios will head to the dugout and will head to the bottom of the seventh inning. Time to stretch here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as the Pios lead 12-5 on the West Coast scoreboard. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Join us for the best college baseball has to offer at the Expedition League All-Star Spectacular, presented by Hydrotex. Two nights of fun start July 19th with the Wyoming Medical Center Fan Fest, featuring Wyoming All-Star Girls Softball, autograph sessions, a free kids clinic, and a home run derby presented by First Interstate Bank. July 20th features the Expedition League All-Star Game and an amazing fireworks show presented by Wyoms. Join us at Mike Lansing Field for the biggest sports event of the summer. Tickets available now at CasperHorseheads.com or by calling 233-4400.
Cuts it to 12-5, and the Pios come to the plate here. It'll be 1-2-3 to kick off the bottom of the seventh as they try and add to their seven-run lead. Smelko, the switch hitter, will bat from the left side again. First pitch he sees, misses low and away. It's ball one. Smelko again, the switch hitter. Not only a switch hitter, also a switch fielder. He played a game this year against the Tommyknockers in left field, left-handed, and then subbed into second base right-handed, and is an ultimate utility guy as this fastball sails high and moves the count to 2-0 as Declan Harper tries to reel it in. Faced one batter in that sixth and struck out Jared Mazzaferro for that final out. And he'll pitch to Smelko here with a 2-0. The pitch home. That one swung on and missed. A sword swing from the left-hander. And the count now moves to 2-1. Smelko 9-for-20 in the four games against the Canyon County Spuds. Four RBIs, five runs, and a pair of doubles. And he's added a hit tonight as well. Has hit safely in the 33 games he's played. Has hit safely in 30 of them. Fantastic stuff as this 2-1's fouled back out of play. And the count will even up in 2-2. Smelko also showing off his range in center field, making a nice running grab in the left center alley earlier tonight. Out of St. Mary's in California and La Mesa, California native. He'll have to protect at the plate as he'll see a 2-2 from Declan Harper. Righty Wines delivers. This one misses low and in, and the count will run full. Nice take from Eric Smelko to work the full count. And you can see why his strikeout totals are so low. 11 strikeouts in his 33 games played. 160 at-bats for him entering tonight in only those 11 Ks. Having to protect here, nobody out, and Harper comes home, full count pitch, swung on and rocked up the middle, a line drive, sails over the glove of the pitcher Harper, and another hit for Eric Smelko. What's new? He's on first base with nobody out to lead off this bottom of the seventh inning. So that'll bring up Cade McGee, tonight's first baseman, as he'll take his fifth trip to the plate. Currently sits 2-for-3 tonight. A walk, a pair of singles, and a pair of runs. He's also thrown out at the plate as part of a 2-4-2 first and third stolen base scenario. And a nice defensive play by second baseman Gunnar Magren to gun him down at the plate. Pickoff to first base, and Smelko dives back in safely. Again, leads the team in stolen bags, but was caught stealing back in the fifth inning. As Harper will try again. So far tonight, Pios 12 runs on 11 hits to the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs 5 on 9 hits as Cade McGee fouls the first pitch away for strike one. McGee again making the All-Star game as a pitcher, as out of relief this year he's got 6 saves and has come in some of the toughest situations for the Pioneers this year and done fantastic. Got his first loss of the year last series against the Canyon County Spuds. Game two, that walk-off 2-RBI single. As that one scoots between the legs of catcher Hannigan, scooting up to second is Eric Smelko, and he'll be in scoring position with nobody out. And the count will even up at 1-1. But with the injury to Dalton Frank, learning this morning that he tore his ACL and will be out for the rest of the season, he's just going to return home and rest up, recover before the spring season starts at Florida Atlantic University. Cade McGee will replace him in the field as an all-star. So a two-way all-star at the plate right now. And recent high school graduate out of Tucson, Arizona. 1-1 home now from the righty Harper as he looks to second and delivers. Check swing there, but he catches the inside part of the plate. And McGee finds himself behind in the count 1-2. Standing in the on-deck circle, Alex Zerfus, who scored 3 runs tonight and has added a pair of RBIs. As we are in the 2-3-4 part of the order, all Gonzaga Bulldogs. As here comes the 1-2 from the righty. That one swung on and rocked foul out to the right side, out of play. Keeps the count where it is. So before the first game of the season, the Pios had a fundraiser home run derby with the Westco Legion team. And Cade McGee and JT Walden both went head-to-head against each other, trying to hit home runs here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. JT, 2 home runs on the year, but he'll compete in the home run derby for the Pioneers in a couple of days during the All-Star game, as that one misses off the plate, evens the count at 2-2. And Cade McGee tied for the team lead with 3 home runs and has tons of power. Biggest home run of the year here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. With the 2-out, nobody on, 3-2 count solo home run, which tied the game in the bottom of the ninth and was followed up by a Dalton Frank walk-off. That 2-2 misses up and in, and the count now runs full 3-2. And you see why he's top 2 in the league in walks. It's because he works counts from behind. Was down in the count early 1-2. It's now 3-2, and Harper's still going to have to deliver to him to try and find the first out. Pitch home. swung on, and this one's hit fairly deep into left center field. Left fielder trying to run it down, still going, leaps, and it falls. It's going to be extra bases as the run will score. Cade McGee will pull up at second, and that will bring home the 13th run for the Pioneers. As slow to get up is Jordan Williams out there in left. Had a long way to go as that one had some arc underneath it, but it kept on going and found the perfect in-between spot from center fielder Alan Greer and Jordan Williams, and that will be ruled a hit and another double for the Pioneers. And for Cade McGee, that's his third of the game, and he brings home another run as the Pios know now they lead 14-5. That's not right. I don't think. You think I would know this as a broadcaster. That's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. A little bit of math here and there. Don't have to do too much as a broadcast major. As Zerfus will hit here following the RBI double from McGee and the pitch home to him. That one misses low for ball one. For Zerfus, he sits with the two RBIs, three runs today, but it was 0-for-5 last night. All five were lineouts or deep flyouts that were squared up at the plate. And I'm sure he was frustrated coming into this one after squaring up every pitch he saw but not being rewarded. Next one home, this one poked foul out to the right side. And the kennel even up at 1-1. Zerfus again on the bus this morning. Everybody else trying to get their sleep in. He had to submit a poetry essay. So he was doing that the entire ride back from Caldwell, Idaho. And I talked to him about it this morning. And he said he finished. It's due Saturday. Proud enough to turn it in as that one misses off the plate. And Zerfus ahead in the count now. We'll see another. Still nobody out here in this bottom of the seventh. The game was cruising along. Currently 9:06 p.m. Mountain Time. As here comes a 1-1 to Zerfus. That one catches the outside corner. It's strike number two. So let's check on some of the scores around the league while we can. The Badlands Big Sticks on top of the Canyon County Spuds at home. Three outs away from closing that one out. It's 10-2 at Dakota Community Bank and Trust Ballpark. As here comes another home to Zerfus. This one swung on, shot down the first baseline, but it just goes foul, and Zerfus will get another pitch to see. The Tommyknockers out in front of the Spearfish Sasquatch in a close one. Top of the eighth at Black Hills Energy Stadium in Spearfish. And the Tommyknockers lead 6-5. The Fremont Moo falling earlier tonight to the Sioux Falls Sunfish 3-1, which means the Sunfish and Moo are now tied atop of the Clark Division at 11-4. A win for the Pioneers would put them one game back of that 11-4 deficit. As here comes the 1-2. Tipped back just enough.
Stay alive!
As another 1-2 will come.
Roll Zags.
Still nobody out. Zerfus will see another with Cade McGee on second base following his RBI double. The next home, this one swung on and made Zerfus chase after the high cheese and goes down his first strikeout of the night. First time he doesn't reach base in his four plate appearances. And he'll go as out number one as J.T. Walden will get another trip to the plate. Walden tonight, three RBIs, including his RBI double in the six, also came around to score a run and is officially 1-for-3.
Next up for your Pios from Gonzaga University, J.T. Walden.
As the first pitch to Walden, that one up and in misses for ball one, and Harper continues to go here in this bottom of the seventh. His pitch count's rising and rising, now up to 25 pitches here and not out of the first inning of work for him. Only one out here after recording the one out in the bottom of the sixth. 1-0 to Walden. This one misses upstairs, and it's now 2-0 as more action in the Souris Valley bullpen over there. Might be their fourth pitcher entering into the game here shortly if Harper can't get around JT Walden at the plate. On deck circle stands Jake English following his RBI double. He's got a pair of hits, a pair of RBIs tonight as Walden dribbles this one out towards second. On the run, the second baseman fields and flips on to first base. They will get out number two, but it's a productive out number two as Cade McGee scoots up to third base. And Walden is retired for the third time tonight. So Jake English walks up to the plate with some Zach Brown Band playing in the background, his walk-up song this year, as he'll look for his third RBI of the night and try and extend this score. It's 13-5 in favor of the Pioneers or here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Neither team really knowing what to expect coming into this one, as Souris Valley had a long bus trip out here and pulled up just before game time, a show and go. The Pioneers also pulling up this afternoon as the first pitch to English catches the inside corner for strike one. So we didn't know if it was going to be a sloppy game or if pitching would be off, bats still asleep after the bus trips, but not the case. 21 hits combined between these two teams, two home runs for the Sabre Dogs, but the Pios out to an 8-run lead as this fastball catches the zone, and English now falls behind 0-2. Cade McGee still on third base out there following his RBI double, which scored the only run of the inning to this point, and English will have to protect at the plate down in the count 0-2. The pitch home from Harper. That one bounces and scoots over the catcher to the backstop, and the flip home not in time. Cade McGee slides in safely. That's run number 14 on a wild pitch from Declan Harper, and it's a 1-2 count now to Jake English with the bases empty as his Pios have a 9-run lead. English still behind in the count and will have to continue to protect against the right-handed Declan Harper. And the kid from Olathe, Kansas, will see another 1-2 home. That one, check swing. Did he go? He did. And that'll go down as out number three as English goes down on strikes. The Pios add two more here in this bottom of the seventh, and we head to the final two frames as the Pios lead 14-5 here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium in game one of this three-game series. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
And no errors. The score now, Sabre Dogs 5, and your Pios 14. And now fans, please direct your attention to the area in front of the Pios dugout as Ryan has tonight's Bud Light Dizzy Bentley. Take it away, Ryan.
Thank you, Bill. I'm down here with Tyler and Hunter, who are going to compete in the Bud Light Dizzy Battery. They're going to start down here by third, chug a beer, run to those bats, spin around five times, and hopefully make it back. Let's count them down, Pio fan. 3, 2, 1, chug! Finish at the same time. I think I'm going to call that one time, huh? I got to put the Bud Light Dizzy Battery. Congrats to both of our competitors. Back up to you, Bill.
All right, thank you, Ryan. And we thank our friends at High Plains Budweiser for joining in the fun of Pirates Baseball. Fans, it's going to be the last call for alcohol. Alcohol sales will end at the end of the break between the eighth inning.
We're back now for the top of the eighth inning. Final two frames about to come your way. Pandoro remains in the game, and he'll pitch to the 8-9-1 in the order for the Sabre Dogs. So leading off here,
leading off for the Sabre Dogs,
will be Gunner
Golden West Jr.
McGran.
Gunner McGran.
He is 2-for-2 tonight, has two singles, a run, and has also been hit by a pitch. The first pitch to him here from Pandoro misses low, and the count starts 1-0. Here comes another, the 1-0. This one shot out into center field. Eric Smelko underneath it. Nice read off the bat by the center fielder, as that's a tough play. The line drive right at you. You don't know whether to take a step in or step back. Smelko did both, but pulled in out number one on the line out, and that's how this eighth inning will get underway.
Now at bat for the Sabre Dogs from the University of San Francisco, Jared Breedwell.
The first pitch home now to the nine-hole hitter, Jared Breedwell, catches the inside part of the plate for strike one. As Pandoro will adjust himself on the rubber before coming home with an 0-1 pitch. The next home, that one swung on and missed, actually tipped into the catcher's mitt behind the plate of Jake English. And it's a quick 0-2 count for the nine-hole hitter and right fielder. Breedwell has flown out tonight, grounded into a double play, and had the sack fly in his most recent trip to the plate. The 0-2 high and away moves it to 1-2 on the outfielder from San Francisco, University of San Francisco, that is, originally from Vacaville, California. As the next home, this one swung on and missed. Pandoro picks up a strikeout, and that'll be out number two here in this top of the eighth. So top of the order back up at the plate, and Pandoro will try and find the cure to Justin Cooper, as he is 4-for-4 tonight, two stolen bags and a run, and has accounted for four of the nine hits tonight for the Sabre Dogs. Almost even with his team in hits. As the first pitch to him, that one, whoa, runs in and misses him. It's ball one. Cooper out of Texas Southern. And 39 starts this year at Texas Southern, playing in the Southwest Athletic Conference. Getting some time against the kid. Whoa, this one on the other side of Cooper. A fastball that he has to scoot out of the way the opposite way towards the plate. And that misses to move the count to 2-0. But Cooper getting some time against Kansas this year, playing a couple games against Kansas on the road, losing both. As that is ball four, and Cooper will trot down to first base, walked on four pitches, and none of them really close, as that will extend the inning with two outs to bring up Alan Greer.
Now at the plate from Chattanooga State University, Alan Greer.
Oh, count now. Greer, the left-handed hitter, will watch this one miss upstairs. It's ball one. Center fielder again out of Chattanooga State Community College. We've seen good action there. As he watches another, this one catches the zone, though, evens the count at 1-1 now.
For Murray State College, Jaden Schaefer.
Yes, here comes another home, no pickoff to first base. So I lied, a replacement at the plate. It's a pinch hitter here, and it'll be Jaden Schaefer out of Murray State College, and the Oklahoma native. We'll see a 1-1 now from Pandoro. This one swung on, hit the other way, fielded on the backhand by Mazzaferro. Can't be fielded cleanly, throw to second, not in time as Cooper beats it out, and that should be ruled a single. As that was a slow hit ball, would have been a tough play, and it will be ruled a hit. So Schaefer comes in and gets the pinch hit single, and it puts runners on first and second with two away.
Now at bat from Minot State University, Jordan Williams.
So runners on first and second now. As Pandoro will try and escape this top of the eighth. First pitch home, outside corner, strike one to Jordan Williams, who's looking to turn his night around. Is 0 for 2, two strikeouts, two pop-ups. So 0 for 4, excuse me. This is his first at bat against Pandoro, though, and he'll start behind in the count 0-1. Out of Minot State University, right-handed hitting left fielder. We'll see another from Pandoro. Pitch home. That one floats too low. No swing, and the count evened at 1-1. Moretto in the on-deck circle for Souris Valley after his solo home run in his last at-bat. He's 1-for-4 on the day. As the 1-1 home, this one swung on and missed, and the count now goes to 1-2. Woo! 1-2 home from Pandoro. This one dribbled off the end of the bat out towards third base. Cutter fields, fired to first, and it's high. Cade McGee comes off the bag and saves a run. Another error from Clay Cutter, but it could have been disaster. Nice vertical from Cade McGee to reel that one in, and reaching safely is Jordan Williams on the air. It'll load the bases now with two away for Steven Moretto.
Now at bat from Sacramento State University, Steven Moretto.
So Moretto at the plate here against Pandoro, as the first two outs of the inning came quickly. This one shot up the middle, and it's going to be a base hit and score a couple of runs. One comes home. The next one comes home without a throw, and it's a two RBI single for Steven Moretto. As once again an error extends the inning, Clay Cutter's throw high over to first base allows two more runs to cross the plate, and now the lead is cut to 7. So make that 7 errors for Clay Cutter in his last 5 games. And really only 3 games needed for those. 3 errors last night, 3 in game 3 against the Big Sticks, and then the one tonight.
From Rice University, Cullen Hannigan.
So Hannigan up at the plate, 1-for-3 tonight, as the first pitch to him misses for ball one, and Pandoro tries to regather himself out there again. Got the quick line out to center field, followed by a quick strikeout to Breedwell for the first two outs of the inning. Since then, a walk, a single, and an error have loaded the bases. Then the two RBI single from Moretto put runners on first and second, two away here, and two still on base. Here's another home to the catcher Hannigan. The 1-0 turns to 2-0 as that misses the mark. The next home, that one misses low, and the count 3-0, three straight balls from Pandoro, and might be a little bit rattled out there after the error on a weak ground ball, which should have ended the inning, has extended it, has allowed two runs to score, and that's now 5 runs in the last 4 innings, including a run at least in every single inning for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. As here comes another, that 3-0 misses its ball 4, and it's a 4-pitch walk to load the bases once again as Pandoro not happy with the call, and that'll bring a visit to the mound. Two outs and the bases loaded for the Sabre Dogs. The left-handed hitter at the plate here against Pandoro, Drew Miller, in a big spot. Bases loaded. As here comes another home, that one in there for strike one as Pandoro tries to regather himself out there. As here comes an 0-1 from the righty. That one just misses on the outer half and evens the count at 1-1 now to the DH, Drew Miller, who started the scoring for the Sabre Dogs. The two-run home run in the second, a walk, a hit by pitch, and then popping up in his only at bat against Pandoro tonight. 1-1 home from the righty. Swung on, hit sharply down the first base line, would foul, and the count goes to 1-2. Pandoro, one strike away from getting out of this jam. Four outs away are the Pioneers from locking up game one against the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. But the Sabre Dogs down by seven with the bases loaded here. Here's a 1-2 from Pandoro. Nods his head, likes the sign, winds and delivers the 1-2 home. Curveball called strike three, drops over the heart of the plate and gets the called strikeout to sit down Miller and in the inning. Pandoro leaves the bases loaded, but two runs cross the plate after an error from Clay Cutter extends the inning. And five straight reach base for the Sabre Dogs. So now we head to the bottom of the eighth as the Pios look for some insurance as they have a seven-run lead. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB.
This time of year, fair.
Why bank at a local community bank? When you choose a local community bank, you keep money in our local economy. That money helps support local jobs, schools, and businesses. Money that helps fund a stronger and prosperous community for us all to enjoy and live in. At Platte Valley Bank, we are here to help build and support the community we love being a part of. We believe that together, we can make great things happen. Platte Valley Bank.
We can sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. Crispy. But also juicy. And tender. Okay, it's crispy, juicy, tender. All one word. But then, also pickle. Oh, and potato bun, which is two words. Okay, we can't sum up our new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. So, you'll just have to try it to understand it. Order ahead on the McDonald's app at participating McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Locally owned and operated since 1907, 506 South Beltline, Scotts Bluff. Online at ideal-linen.com or call 632-7197.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now as the Pios come to the plate once again. As is a new arm into the game for the Sabre Dogs. It's a position player pitching as we've reached that point in the night. Number 24 is into the game. That's Taylor Justice. Agora Hills, California. This will be his first pitching performance, but has batted in 15 games this year as an infielder. Four doubles, nine RBIs for him, but we'll get to see what he has on the mound as the Pios will come to the plate once again, hopefully for the last time in this one.
Good pitcher on the mound for the Sabre Dogs, Taylor Justice. And leading off for the Pios from Iowa Western Community College, Ryan Hutter.
First pitch home, that one catches the outside corner on Clay Cutter for strike one. Cutter trying to avenge himself, adding another error in this one. After sailing a ball to first base to extend the inning, two runs would score after it. And at the plate here, quickly down in the count, 0-2. So Cutter steps in and steps back out as he calls time, but quickly regathers himself, and Justice comes home. The 0-2 swung on and missed. A strikeout on three pitches for Taylor Justice entering to the game, and that's not a bad way to start your pitching career for the Sabre Dogs as Cutter goes down on strikes. So that'll bring up Nate Schwartz. He gets an at-bat here.
Now at bat from Ohlone Junior College.
He's currently 0-3, struck out, flied out, grounded out, and walked in his four trips to the plate tonight. 1-0 home. After the first pitch, misses for a ball. And Justice will quickly bring home another. This one swung on and fouled back, even as the count at 1-1. All you can really ask for a position player pitching is to fill the zone, and Justice has certainly done that to this point, as it is a 1-1 count now to Nate Schwartz. And the right-handed hitting catcher in DH tonight, we'll see a 1-1. This one swung on, fouled away out to the right side, and Justice has himself another 1-2 count. Wind starting to pick up here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You can see the flag almost coming off the flagpole in left field as the dust is blowing through. This one's high for ball two to even the count at two apiece. From the left field foul pole. We saw that the other night before the Pios traveled to Caldwell, Idaho, as the 2-2 home. This one drops into the zone. A curveball called strike three. Back-to-back K's for Taylor Justice on the mound. And Kellen Rutz will come up to the plate after two quick K's for Taylor Justice. So Rutz batting from the left side here, trying to avoid going down 1-2-3 in this bottom of the eighth inning, as that one misses up and in, and it's ball one. So now four errors for the Pioneers after a scoring change. There was an error on Jared Mazzaferro in that last inning, as that one swung on and missed, and the count now 1-1. It's been three straight strikeouts for pitching for the Sabre Dogs, including four strikeouts in the last five batters faced following the RBI double from Cade McGee. 1-1. That one misses upstairs in the count now. 2-1 to the second baseman, Kellen Rutz. He has two RBIs tonight and is 1-3. An RBI double, the RBI ground out, and then the normal ground out to first base, and a walk on a run as well. 2-1 count. Justice out of the windup will set, deliver, pitch. This one swung on and missed, and the count now 2-2. I got to tell you, I will definitely be giving the dugout grief if Taylor Justice strikes out the side as a position player. Kellen Rutz trying to prevent that from happening after he had his first outing the other day. And he goes down on strikes. Fastball outside corner. And Taylor Justice strikes out the side. And that wraps up this bottom of the eighth inning. We head now to the ninth. Pios lead 14-7 and look for three more outs to close it out here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEB.
Hi, I'm Kathy Birch from Van Newkirk Real Estate. Van Newkirk Real Estate is more than a realtor. We're your helping hand of knowledge when it comes to the investment you'll make buying that perfect home. We help you discover what's right for you and your financial situation. Whether you need commercial, residential, farm property, no one will compare to the service we're about to give you. Call one of our agents today at 632-8700 for the best real estate help possible, and we're happy to show you that service is what we sell.
The Christmas in July sale is going on right now at Vieira Wireless, and we invite you to come in and see just how big the savings are. You'll get up to $1,000 off iPhone plus other top brands. We're your trusted local source for iPhone and iPad. So bring your family, transfer your numbers, and get an extra $200 per line. Let us take care of you by making the transfer easy and free of hassle and hidden fees. For Christmas in July savings, come visit your local Vieira store today.
Life has a way of throwing unexpected events and new opportunities our way. When life goals change with time or if fluctuating markets throw your plan off course, Wells Fargo Advisors investment planning process offers the flexibility to make the adjustments you need to help you live the life you want. When life happens, we can help. For more information, call Ryan Windhorst, Senior Vice President of Investments, today at 632-7561. That's 632-7561.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Leading off for the Sabre Dogs from Murray State College, Ethan Mill.
Top of the ninth inning, Pios try and close this one out. First pitch from Pandoro swung on and missed, and Ethan Moore starts behind in the count 0-1. He's 0 for 4 on the day. And trying to bounce back in this one. Moore, his team is leading 7-14 here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Game one of a three-game set. Fastball upstairs, swung on and missed. And the count quickly 0-2 on the first baseman as Pandoro looks for back-to-back strikeouts after ending the top of the eighth with one. 0-2 count, Pandoro pumps, winds, delivers. This one poked out into right field, and it'll be a base hit. And it'll allow a runner to reach a leadoff single on an 0-2 pitch. Nice piece of hitting from Ethan Moore to choke up and push it the other way. He'll start off the inning with a single and put runner on first base and nobody out.
Next batter from Golden West Junior College, Gunnar McGrand.
That one in there for strike one on Gunnar McGrand, who has two hits tonight, is 2-for-3 to this point. They trail by 7 in this one. But have a runner on, nobody out. Pandoro comes home. This one misses off the plate. And that'll be ball one. So the first batter Pandoro faces was the solo home run in the seventh. As here comes the 1-1 to the plate. This one swung on, struck out into right center field, and it's going to drop in for extra bases. That one goes to the wall, rounding second and heading to third. They're going to hold him there, and it'll be a double to put runners in scoring position with nobody out. Pandoro is still looking for the final three outs of this one. Now has two in scoring position for the Sabre Dogs, and the nine-hole hitter up before the top of the order.
Next batter for the Sabre Dogs from the University of San Francisco, Jared Breedwell.
So Jared Breedwell comes to the plate from the University of San Francisco.
And the Dr. Pepper.
a pitcher there. Had three appearances, two innings of work. Has not had a collegiate at-bat yet, a freshman in 2021. We'll watch this one break too low, and the count goes to 1-0. For Breedwell this season for the Sabre Dogs, though. He has played 14 games, a .286 average in 35 at-bats. He skies this one out to the right side. Cade McGee works his way underneath it, still wobbling, but catches it in fair territory for out number one, and it keeps the runners at second and third. So that brings up the top of the order as Justin Cooper comes up to the plate once again for the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. He'll face Pandoro for the second time after being walked on four pitches in the eighth, and then he came around to score one of the two runs in that eighth inning.
That's the top of the order for the Sabre Dogs from Texas Southern University, Justin Cooper.
Yes, here comes the first. That one misses off the plate, gets away, scoots by English, and the run's going to come across to score. As now to the throw to the plate, still gets away. And it's live until it's picked up, now dead. As that is now an 8-14 ball game as another run comes home to score off of Pandoro. This one shot out towards third, fielded by Cutter. He'll fire on to first base, that one in time, and it's out number two. So Cooper's out for the first time tonight. Finally, the Pios find a way to get him out, and Schaefer will come up for his second AB, reached on an error in his first at-bat, and then came around to score after it was initially ruled a single but was overruled and given the error.
Murray State College, Jaden Schaefer.
And left-handed hitting Schaefer will see the first pitch from Pandoro. Swung on and missed. Good fastball for strike one as Pandoro starts ahead. Pios one out away from sealing up this 14-8 win here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. And game one of a three-game series, starting out hot at home and continuing that home streak. This one, outside corner. Fastball moves the count to 0-2. Pandoro one pitch away.
All right, Pios fans, let's hear some of that Western.
Out of the windup, Pandoro pumps and comes home. 0-2 pitch, this one. Fastball just misses high, and it'll move to 1-2 now. As on third base is Gunnar McGrand, the second baseman, trying to avoid being left stranded out there. The 1-2 home from Pandoro. That one low, scoots by English, but not far enough for the runner to advance, as it is now a 2-2 count, and Pandoro will have to try again. Pios looking to advance to 18-3 at home, and 32-12 on the season, move within one game of the Clark Division lead in the second half. 2-2 count, two away, runner on third base. Pandoro nods, pumps his arms, and delivers. 2-2, that one upstairs as well. And after starting ahead 0-2, it's now a full 3-2 count. On deck is Jordan Williams, who has an 0-for-5 line today. Reached in his most recent at-bat on an error. Pandoro will try again. 3-2. Swung on, dribbled towards the on-deck circle, and Schaefer stays alive to see another. Pandoro already up to 60 pitches out of relief in this one, and looking for out number three to close this game out. Fans start to clap on their feet at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. The 3-2 pitch. Swung on, dribbled slowly out towards second. Kellen Rutz on the run, underhand, flips the first in time for out number three. The Pios take down the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs in game one of the three-game series here at home. They advance to 18-3 at home and 32-12 on the year, as well as 9-4 in the Clark Division in this second half. Back again tomorrow night As they'll take on the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs for game two, both teams will get a little bit of rest after those long bus rides today and then be back tomorrow night to take on each other in game two. Pios will go for the series win in that one. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll have the Runs of Post Game show, wrap everything up, get our Taco John's player of the game up here, and then get you set up for the broadcast tomorrow. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said,
"Get your hands off my burrito."
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations in Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
Embrace summer with a Platte Valley Bank home equity line of credit. Relax on your new deck. Get cooking in your recently renovated kitchen or finally finish the basement. You can even consolidate debt and enjoy lower monthly payments just by using the equity in your home. With great rates and fast, friendly lenders, now is the time to embrace summer and tackle projects that will make the whole family happy. Learn more at www.pvbank.com.
Platte Valley Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
Man, flies are annoying, aren't they? Especially when there could be 2,000 of them sitting on each cow in your herd. This can lead to stress that ultimately cuts down into your bottom line. And that's even more annoying. Using Purina Wind and Rain Mineral with fly control can help cut down the horn fly population. And it doesn't clump up, so there's no waste. Which means you can get less of that annoying fly buzz and more of that good buzz when people see how great your cattle look. Feed with greatness with Purina Wind, Rain, and Mineral with fly control. Learn more at Marker Ag at 718 21st Avenue in Scotts Bluff. Or call us at 633-1057 or like us on Facebook.
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
Brandon is super pumped about Runza.
Runza is so sweet.
Especially all their desserts.
Oh, those are the sweetest.
Chocolate, vanilla, and twist ice cream cones, 4 flavors of shakes, chocolate chip cookies, and ice cream sandwiches.
Literally sweet.
Aw, I love your enthusiasm.
Well, I love Runza.
So sweet of you. Come satisfy your sweet tooth. Because from the way we make it to the way it makes you feel, Runza makes it all better.
It's time now for the Runza Postgame Show, presented by Runza Restaurants. Runza makes a great stop before or after every game. Win or lose, Runza makes it all better. Now with the Runza Postgame Show, once again, Zach McKinstry.
Time now for the Runza Postgame Show. Runza doesn't like to think of themselves as just another restaurant in town. They like to think of themselves as part of the community. Runza with locations in Scottsbluff, Gearing, and Chadron. Pios take game one against the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs, 14-8. After a good one here, featured a lot of good Pioneers bats. 2 hits for Eric Smelko, 3 for Cade McGee, 1 for Zerfus. He had a pair of RBIs, 3 for JT Walden, the team leader in that category. Jake English added 2 more in a 2-hit day, and Clay Cutter added an RBI as well. Kellen Rutz with 2 more, and the Pios really getting it done at the plate today with their tons of hits. They finished with 12 of them at the plate. Caden Edwards got the start and went 6 innings, allowing 3 earned, 3 walks, 4 strikeouts for him, and a good enough outing to earn the win tonight as the Sabre Dogs fall here in game one. Let's take a look at some of the scores going on around the league as most of them are wrapped up by this point. Of course, the Pios taking out the Sabre Dogs 14-8. The Mining City Tommyknockers are in extra innings with the Spearfish Sasquatch top of the 8th, but they've put up 3 runs in that top half of the 10th. And lead 8-5 in Spearfish. The Sioux Falls Sunfish took down the Moo 3-1 at Karras Park. The Sodbusters won 10-6 over the Casper Horseheads at Duncan Field. The Wheat City Whiskey Jacks took down the Pure Trappers 12-2 following being no hit yesterday. And the Badlands Big Sticks won 10-2 over the Canyon County Spuds at home in Dickinson, North Dakota. One more quick break here on the Runza Postgame Show. When we come back, Taco John's Player of the Game and wrap things up here on the Runza Postgame Show. You're listening to Pios Baseball.
Join us for the best college baseball has to offer at the Expedition League All-Star Spectacular, presented by Hydrotex. Two nights of fun start July 19th with the Wyoming Medical Center Fan Fest, featuring Wyoming All-Star Girls Softball, autograph sessions, a free kids clinic, and a home run derby presented by First Interstate Bank. July 20th features the Expedition League All-Star Game and an amazing fireworks show presented by Wyoms. Join us at Mike Lansing Field for the biggest sports event of the summer. Tickets available now at CasperHorseheads.com or by calling 233-4400.
Oils, greases, and fuel improvers. Hydrotex's main priorities are to provide the best products and the most efficient and reliable service to fit the customer's application needs. For more information on how Hydrotex can help you, call Phil and Nick at 308-635-8162. Stop into our new showroom at 2860 Holiday Park Drive in Gearing and see the products and services they offer, as well as purchase any products that you need.
Drive happy this summer with auto insurance from J.G. Elliott. Hi, I'm Lila Nash, and when you choose J.G. Elliott as your auto insurance provider, you'll get a variety of options and deductibles, including car rental coverage and customized equipment coverage, so you can get on the road without the worry. If a new boat, motorcycle, RV, or ATV is part of your summer plan, we can insure that too. Plus, you can bundle your vehicle and home insurance to save even more. J.G. Elliott has insurance coverage for all your summer adventures. J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
We're back now for the Taco John's Player of the Game. The Player of the Game is brought to you by Taco John's of Scottsbluff and Gehring. Make Taco John's a game day tradition by unwrapping the original before or after every game. Caden Edwards got the start today, got your first win of the year after your second longest outing of the year, six innings of work, and your team got it done offensively. You carried the way through those six innings. How was it out there?
Pitching against a good team, that's probably the best team I've thrown against all summer. Didn't have my best stuff, but what I had, I used and I got some outs.
Yeah, and you made some nice plays out there, had some defense behind you, and you had a great outing offensively. Cade McGee with a nice day at the plate with a lot of other Zags getting it done. I think the Gonzaga boys combined for like six RBIs, seven runs, but when you get that offensive production behind you, how much easier is it to pitch on the mound?
It is. It's a lot of help, especially when you give up a few runs early, and then to get them back like that gives me a lot of confidence to go out there.
Yeah, first win of the year again, the second longest outing for you on the year. Is there something that you're doing to try and extend further into games throughout the year?
Basically, throw as many strikes as possible and get as many quick outs as possible. So
you pounded the zone today, added four strikeouts and three walks on the day. But congratulations on your first win of the year, and good luck the rest of the way. I know you're going to the All-Star game at the end of this series, so looking forward to that. And Casper?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
All right. Caden Edwards, everybody, the Taco John's Player of the Game. One more break here on the Runza Postgame Show, and when we come back, we'll tell you what time broadcast is tomorrow. You're listening to Pios Baseball on the Runza Postgame Show on KNEB.
Inventory, supply, demand, marketing, human resources. It takes a lot to manage your business. But when your team includes the professionals at E&H CPAs and Management Consultants PC, the burden is lightened because you know the accounting, tax planning, valuation services, even litigation support and exit planning are taken care of. Troy Hilliard, Seth Cobalt, and Lindsay Matthews bring years of experience in guiding your business. E&H CPAs and Management Consultants PC, 2021 Broadway, innovative, trusted, proven.
So the dream was to build your very own law practice, be your own boss, call all the shots. But have things like billing, HR, timekeeping, and all the other management stuff turned your dream into a nightmare? Take charge of your practice with Lexicon. We're the intersection of practice management software and legal support services for your firm. You'll get more billable and livable hours back. Lexicon marks the spot for all your practice management needs. Visit lexiconservices.com/intersection to get the whole story or schedule a demo.
Our mission at Elite Physical Therapy and Wellness is to provide both preventative and rehabilitative services. At Elite Physical Therapy in Scottsbluff and Gearing, patients count on the experience and compassion of our team in treating work and sports injuries, help you recover from surgery, or just help you get back doing what you love most. Flexible scheduling to meet your needs, and we are right here in Scottsbluff and Gearing to serve you. Katie and Shelley are across from Walgreens on West 27th Street and next to Fresh Foods and Gearing. Elite Physical Therapy and Wellness, delivering the treatment you need and the care you deserve.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now on the Runza postgame show as we wrap things up here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Pioneers win this one by a score of 14-8 against the Souris Valley Sabre Dogs. Back again tomorrow night as game two, the Pios will try and win the series. It'll be first pitch at 6:35 and we'll be live at 6:20 as always. Looking for a beautiful Saturday afternoon in Gearing. Pios trying to win the series in that one, so make sure you're tuning in for everyone involved in the broadcast. I'm Zach McKinstry. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you tomorrow.
This has been the Runza Postgame Show, presented...